I guess it's time for the event, eh? Does this event have voice acting? I'm going to assume it does, right? YouTube, welcome in! Today, we are testing our courage with Ayato. Ayato and Ayato. Let's do this. Ayato! Long time no see!
Ah, it's you two. Yes, it has been a while.
It's been a long time, actually. A very long time.
We heard the Yashiro Commission is holding a test of courage, so we came right over to sign ourselves up.
Yes, we did.
We didn't expect to see you here in person, though. Does that mean this event is really important?
You think I only make an appearance for occasions that are deemed sufficiently important?
For the most part, to be fair.
It just so happens that this Test of Courage event was actually my suggestion.
Oh!
But, naturally, I've left the planning and more trifling details to be arranged by my retainers. Considering that such events are quite popular across Teyvat, I've had numerous examples to draw from, so everything should be in good order. I'm merely here to do a routine check on the progress of the event. That's all.
Interesting.
Everyone gets it. So what you're saying is you're not very busy right now.
That's a given.
In that case, maybe you can give us a quick rundown of the event rules.
Yes. I'm actually curious about this.
Only Paimon could be so natural at ordering others around.
True.
However, the possibility remains that we may yet require your assistance.
Oh?
Sorry. What did you say?
Huh?
Nothing. Seeing as I apparently have some time, I suppose we may chat about the event for a moment.
Look like Paimon had a headache. Thanks, Ayato.
As its name implies, the event is a game designed to put one's courage to the test.
Yeah.
The venue for the event will be set up in the Chinju Forest. Before the start of each round, participants will be divided into teams of two.
I forgot we have the new Yippee emote. Spam it, chat. Yippee!
Once teams have been formed, the event staff will announce the name of an item that has been placed in or around the Chinju Forest area.
Oh. Okay.
The first person to locate the specified item will be declared the winner of that round.
It's like Wind Trace, but with an object.
The winner of that round? Huh. So there's gonna be multiple rounds to the Test of Courage?
Precisely. There will be a total of 3 rounds in the Test of Courage because the event was actually orchestrated by 3 different parties.
Oh.
Merchants raised event funding, the Kamisato clan provided the grounds, and the Grand Narukami Shrine provided consulting services. As such, each of these 3 parties have selected 1 item for participants to find. So, naturally, the event will require 3 rounds to determine the winners.
Imagine it's just like, yeah, can you go find the Hydrognosis?
Gets it? So basically, it boils down to searching for stuff in Chinju Forest.
Yes.
We'll need to find 1 item each round for a total of 3 items after 3 rounds. Huh. Simple enough for Paimon.
Yes.
Simple enough for me.
Since you got the gist of it. We will be issuing different rewards based on the number of rounds won. So, if a participant wins multiple rounds, then that will also be reflected in their final reward.
I just want the Wanderer.
If a participant manages to find all 3 items, then they shall receive the grand prize provided by the Grand Narukami Shrine.
Ooh.
Ooh, a grand prize? Sounds like it could be really valuable.
As for its true value, I'm afraid you'll have to win the event first and ask Lady Guji yourself. Of course, this event is intended to measure your courage. If you withdraw from the event because you become too frightened, then you might as well forget about seeing any rewards.
Bro, I would love if they actually made this kind of horror.
I'm curious myself how many people will be brave enough to make it to the end. It'll be most disappointing if nobody claims the prizes we've prepared.
Nah, we'll claim the prizes.
Those prizes are as good as ours!
Mm-hmm. We'll definitely win.
Even though just the thought of this event sends shivers down Paimon's little spine, the traveler will be brave enough, no doubt about that.
That's right.
I appreciate your enthusiasm. I look forward to seeing how you perform.
Also, can I just say this? And I don't know if this is a purposeful thing again with the voice acting direction for Paimon. For some reason, in the past like 3 patches, she sounds like in between old Paimon and new Paimon. Is that just me? It sounds like the voice is kind of balanced out.
Anyway, I think I've given you sufficient details. I'll add your names to the list of participants momentarily.
I like it.
As for the 3 items you'll be searching for, please wait for a staff member to inform you at the start of the event. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. Test of Courage events tend to give rise to a variety of strange rumors and
trailer
stories.
Line.
So please, be sure to exercise caution.
Whoa, what did he mean by that? Oh, will there be spooky things in Tindu Forest?
It's certainly a possibility.
Now even you're trying to scare Paimon.
True.
Anyway, we got an event to win. Grand prize, here we come.
Pog. Okay, maybe not for every line. Just some lines. Yeah, it's a mixture. Okay, here we go. Leave the Yashiro Commission. I want to see what this event even is, because I have no clue. I literally haven't seen a thing about this event other than the trailer for it. Ito! My man, my bro, my dude!
Hold it right there. Oh, well, if it isn't my compadre.
Oh, hell yeah.
Didn't expect to see you here.
Yeah, I didn't expect to see you here.
Huh? Paimon knows that voice. It's Ito! What are you doing here?
Why does she look disappointed?
Oh, wait, don't tell Paimon you're here for the test of courage.
Ha, what else? I'm sorry, but those prizes already belong to yours truly. Arataki ain't scared of nothing, Ito.
Ito, you're fucking scared of your own shadow. Paimon's face.
I mean, well, that's what I really want to say. But I have actually got something else going on.
Oh? What's that?
Yeah, what is
it's
that?
A long story. As soon as I heard about the test of courage, I got the gang together and was ready to bring everyone for the time of their lives.
Ah, okay.
But it turns out the other members weren't as pumped about the event as me. Jinju Forest? We've already been there a million times. There's
well, that was
nothing
weird.
Scary about that place. That event's just a game for kids. What a waste of time. Let's play some genius invocation TCG.
Yeah!
Seriously? Test of courage? Ugh, whatever. I guess if that's what the boss wants.
Oh my god.
Can you believe that? What a group of deadbeats. Not gonna put up with that? Nuh-uh, not in my gang.
Fair.
Oh, Paimon gets it now. Dragging the gang to an event they don't want to go to won't be the best for your reputation as a leader.
Hey, this isn't about me.
It's about the TCG.
As leader of the Arataki gang, it's my duty to find new and tantalizing experiences for everyone. Mm. A happy gang means a happy life. Even if they can't get it through their stubborn heads now, one way or another, I'll show them how much fun a test of courage can be.
Wow, Ito, you should be care about your gang members.
Anyway, I'm no stranger to Chinju Forest. Sure, it was a little terrifying going through there, but hey, I'm used to it now.
Yeah, that's understandable.
What kind of scary pranks could those guys in the Yashiro Commission ever come up with? If they can't scare anyone, then it's not going to be a test of courage, now is it? Not to mention, if the gang starts complaining, I will never be able to show my face around here.
Yeah. After all that talk, it still boils down to you.
True. Well, leading a gang can be complicated. You don't understand. Anywho, I've got a plan.
We literally run the entire show, Ito! We have like 50 characters, including you!
Since there's no way I can trust the Yashiro Commission to make a fun event,
God
I've decided
it.
To step in and spice things up a little.
Wait!
Oh god.
You don't seriously mean that!
Oh no.
Oh, you bet I do! Yours truly is gonna be out scaring people! I'm taking this event to a whole nother level!
He did scare me in the trailer.
It's gonna take more than an Oni to make it happen, so I came here to recruit some help. And then I saw you come walking along!
Oh.
Come on, come scare people with me, please!
Oh, I'm down, I'd rather do that.
No
way! Paimon, shut the fuck up, I would rather
Pretty
do that.
Please?
Yes.
Forget it!
Paimon!
Pretty, pretty, please!
Come on.
Fine.
Yes!
But don't forget, we're here to win the test of courage and take home the grand prize!
Yes! I'm so happy.
If you're out, just don't get in the way of our prize!
Yes! You're a real Oni saver! Hey, don't worry, with me around, winning the test of courage will be a piece of cake.
Agreed.
Alright, those participants won't scare themselves. Let's get out there!
Let's do this shit.
What a noisy guy.
True. I mean...
But after hearing him laugh and talk,
you're also noisy,
Paimon. Doesn't feel scared anymore. Huh. Maybe laughter is the key to making fear go away. If things get scary later, we can all start laughing at the top of our lungs.
Pretty sure that just made things even scarier.
Hey, Traveler, Paimon, enough chit-chat. We're gonna miss the event.
Coming!
Pretty sure it would just make things scarier, you know? Madamenis, think of the 5-month resub. Hey, Zoo! Oh, shit. It's actually going to be at an event. Jesse. James. We're blasting off again.
That's going to hurt in the morning.
Meowth. That's right. I don't know. Sorry. I had to do it. Duke, that's right.
All right. This looks like the place. Is it just Paimon, or does it look a lot scarier than usual here?
I think it is just Paimon. It looks the same. It looks the exact same.
Hey, Paimon.
Oh my god, Ito, Jesus fucking Christ.
Don't speak up on Paimon like that! What do you want?
Stop it!
Nah, nothing. I just had a thought occur to me.
What?
I want to scare the gang members real good, but now that I think about it, I've never actually scared anyone before.
Motherfucker, you scared me in the trailer, and you kinda just scared me then a little bit.
You're only now realizing this?
So you mean you want to practice first?
Practice? Oh, now there's an idea. Hey, I've got it. Why don't you join the test of courage like everyone else, and I'll go hide and try to scare you from time to time. Then you two can judge my scaring skills. All right, that's the plan. Let me go get ready. Just wait. You'll see how scary this Oni can be.
I cannot help that.
And there he goes, running off and still talking to himself. Well,
oh god.
We were here to join the event anyway. Guess we'll just have to pass Ito's little test along with whatever else the event throws at us. Oh.
I agree.
Seems one of the event staff is over there.
Oh,
let's
no.
Let's go talk to
her. Oh god, okay. It reminds me of the Kitsune lady from the Secret Sakura quest. Oh, it's just a shrine maiden. Okay, let's go. Let's go.
Uh-huh. You must be here to participate in the test of courage.
Why, yes, I am, shrine maiden.
That's right. Judging from your outfit, you must be one of the shrine maidens from the Grand Narukami Shrine.
Yes.
That's right. Huh. I can already see a dark aura surrounding the two of you. Yes. Truly ominous.
Uh-oh.
If you carelessly go running into the event, all it'll take is one little misstep, and the darkness will swallow you up.
Okay. Ooh. It was scary before the mwahahahaha.
Is she really a shrine maiden?
Sure you don't want to back out? This is your last chance. I'll count it down. 3, 2...
Okay, I'm out!
1.
Four.
Welcome to the test of courage. Enter at your own risk.
Oh, was that the first test?
Sure, you could say that. You know, the most unfortunate tales always happen unexpectedly on just a normal, average day. Just like today.
What is that supposed to mean?
No need to worry. Allay your qualms and suspicions. Everything was already set into motion the moment you two stepped into this place. Just enjoy the calm before the storm.
Oh, God.
The first round is about to begin. Have you already decided on your partner?
Yep, Ito.
Ah, you finally said something that Paimon can understand. Yep, the two of us will be partners. We always make the best team.
What? Wait, why couldn't she understand anything else? It made perfect sense.
But it appears your names were written together as a single participant. The Traveler and Paimon.
True. We're going with Ito.
Which means you'll have to find yourselves another partner in order to join the event.
Wait, are you serious?
Yeah, Ito!
If only Ito hadn't gone running off on his own, we could have had a partner!
We go find him.
Now what should we do?
Go find him!
As far as I know, there have been other participants who've yet to designate a partner.
Yes! Yes!
You could go ask around. Just be sure to make it quick. If you don't have a partner by the time the event starts, then you'll be immediately disqualified.
Hey, what?
Uh-oh. We can't let that happen.
Where's it start?
Let's see if we can find anyone to partner up with nearby.
Oh, shit. Okay. Let's go talk to Ayaya first. Hey, Ayaya.
Oh, Traveler and Paimon. Greetings.
Well, hello there.
Huh? It's Ayaka. Are you here for the test of courage, too?
Probably.
Yes. My brother told me that the event would be most interesting, and suggested that I personally participate. I have never experienced a Test of Courage event, so I don't really know what to expect.
Oh, so this is your first time?
To be frank, I'm no expert when it comes to the supernatural. I often worry that I haven't shown spirits proper respect, and have brought shame upon my clan.
Jesus.
Oh, speaking of which, may I ask if the two of you are partners for the event?
Actually, the Shrine Maiden just told us that we only count as a single participant. However that works. So, we're looking for a partner now.
We're the same person.
Splendid. In that case, how would you like to be my partner? I always feel at ease when you're by my side. But of course, please don't let me get in the way if you wish to participate with someone else.
Well, now I just feel bad, dude. Now I just feel bad. Let me think about it.
Sure. I understand. I'll be waiting for you here. You may let me know if you need anything.
Now I don't want to go to Dr. Goro, because, oh no. Maybe I'll take Goro instead of Kazu. Speak to me, Goro.
Goro!
Oh, Traveler, Paimon. I didn't expect to run into you here.
I feel like...
We're here for the test of courage. How about you?
Okay, hear me out here, chat. Hear me out here. I feel like the majority of people are going to go for this fucking creepy-ass dude up here. Why is he just there? I feel like they're going to go for Kazu. Because everyone loves Kazu. I also love Kazu. I feel like the funnier one would be Goro, because I feel like a lot of people are also going to pick Ayaya, and a lot of people aren't going to pick Goro, and Goro deserves some head pats. But I feel like Goro would be fucking hilarious, because he's a massive pussy, dude. He's terrified of everything. He's terrified of Yai!
Well, I was originally headed to Yai Publishing House to hand in the responses for this month's issue of That's Life, but I had no idea that that crafty fox would be there. She brought up the Test of Courage event and suggested I give it a try. I wasn't interested, but she said, "The mighty general of Watatsumi Island isn't afraid of anything, is he?" And before I knew it, I found myself caught in her persuasive mind games.
Yep.
I immediately regretted it the moment I arrived here. There could be traps everywhere.
Oh... This event's sounding more and more dangerous.
It is sounding spoofy.
My instinct tells me that the forest is chock full of ambushes. One misstep, and it'll be over.
Probably.
Perhaps that, crafty fox is hiding somewhere in the dark, waiting for another opportunity to tease me. Who knows? She might even use a camera and send embarrassing photos back to Watatsumi Island. Her Excellency once said, "When you march into an ambush, escape the enemy vanguard. When escape is impossible, then seek ample reinforcements."
I feel like he's the best choice.
Now that you're here, maybe we can turn the tables.
Oh.
Could I ask you two to partner up with me?
All right, let me think about it for now. I do want to hear what the others have to say.
I completely understand. Perhaps you have a friend you'd like to enter the test of courage with? Anyway, whoever you decide to partner up with, the most important thing is to enjoy the event. Good luck.
Oh, God. Okay, let me go talk to Kazu. I genuinely, at the minute, am very tempted to pick Goro. All right, let's listen.
There was a familiar scent upon the wind. I knew that I'd see you around here.
Did he just say I can smell you?
Kazuha!
We meet again.
We do.
Paimon didn't expect to see you at the Test of Courage.
And why's that? Do I seem unsuited for this sort of event?
No.
Oh, no, not at all. It's just that Paimon's never seen you get scared, Kazuha. Mm. You're always so calm and collected. It's like you've never been scared by anything.
True.
You flatter me. I suppose that's only a reflection of my time wandering in the wilderness.
Wandering?
I've heard many strange stories in my travels.
Fair.
I can say I've even experienced a few myself. Over time, I must have gotten used to it.
Ah, that makes sense. But,
I like Kazu.
Why do you want to join the Test of Courage?
After hearing the Yashiro Commission promote the rewards for this event, I was guessing that you two would show up. Since we hadn't seen each other for some time, I figured I might as well come and see you. After all, meeting someone after being apart for so long always lifts the spirits.
Oh, so you were waiting for us?
Simp.
That's right. So tell me, how has your journey been lately?
Oh, great. We met Scaramouche. He tried to kill us.
By the way, the Shrine Maiden told us that everyone needs a partner to participate in the Test of Courage event. Have you found a partner yet, Kazuha?
No, not yet. Do you need me to be your partner?
Let me think about it.
Take your time. We'll have plenty of chances to talk later, so there's no need to make a choice this very instant. We could even go together for a late-night snack once the event is over.
Sid! I love him, though. Now, let me have a quick look around first and foremost, because we have Ayaka, we have Kazu, We have Tanuki, which I assume we cannot take on the event with us. Is it just these three is the question? I think it is. It's actually a tough choice for me because I don't want to take Ayaka. I'm sorry, Ayaka. I'm very sorry. Kazuha, I love as a character. I do love Kazuha as a character, but he's not here because of the test of courage. He's here because of us. And we're going to get to hang out with him afterwards, he said. Goro is here for the test of courage. I feel like he would be the best and funniest choice. Plus, hear me out here, chat. How many of y'all have already chosen Kazuha? Do you want to see Goro's instead of Kazuha's? Because I could always watch another one for Kazuha's as well. I feel like a lot of people ain't going to pick Goro, so I feel like it might be the more interesting route to go down. I'm going to do it. I'm going with Goro, dude. I literally, on the kin test, I got Goro. I am Goro. Let's go.
Oh, have you decided whether or not to participate with me?
Yes, for some reason, I want to partner up with the biggest wimp of them all.
Great. This will be your chance to fight side by side once again. With you around, there's nothing to fear. That crafty fox's games are over.
Wait till you see me transform into her in a second. Oh, that was Ayato. He died.
Ah, it looks like you found yourself a partner. The event is just about to start. I will now reveal the item you'll be looking for in the first round.
Milk.
It's called Dongo Milk. Woo.
Okay. The ooh was unnecessary. I'm a genius, and I definitely didn't just see milk on the board.
Dango milk?
Correct. Tomoki was kind enough to provide us with his dango milk, and it has been hidden somewhere in the Chinju forest.
Okay.
The path will be marked with signs to guide you, but some strange and unusual things may occur along the way. If you ever feel you can't handle it, you may withdraw from the event at any time. Now, if you're ready, then you may begin.
Okay.
Beat us to it. Let's go.
All right, let's go. Trigger warning, dango milk. Huh? What if I just don't follow the signs? What if the whole test of courage is wandering off the road?
There may be ambushes waiting in the forest. Let's stick to the road signs.
Shut up. Fuck. Hey, Goro, follow me.
There's something off about this place.
Yeah?
This unsettling feeling reminds me of a strange story I heard among the troops.
You can go
a
forward, you know.
A strange story? Is it scary?
According to the story, there was an army that was marching through a deserted forest.
Whoa.
When they discovered a stockpile of delicious food.
Oh.
The troops were short on provisions, so they came to a halt and began to eat heartily. Before long, they suddenly noticed several pairs of blood-red eyes staring at them.
Spin! I'll give you a treat.
I'm uncertain enough.
He's chasing his tail.
Scary story.
He was chasing his tail, dude. Do I have any treats for you? Hold on. Maybe I've got a treat that he can have. What would a dog like to eat? Tentacles. Wait! Ah! Oh, there's so many different paths! Oh, no! You want to go for a walk by the lake? No, to the spooky, scary skeletons.
Just as I predicted, they're coming right our way.
Yes, scary.
It's time, Ushi. Let's give him a scare.
Ushi,
a surprise attack! I can't see anything.
Ushi, let's go.
It's an ambush! Everyone, fall back!
Hell no! Wait, no, I don't want to fall back. I don't want to fall back. Okay, yeah, we're going this way.
There may be ambushes waiting in the forest. Oh. Let's stick to the road signs.
Wait, there are more signs. Wait, was this was the right way? I found the milk. Wait, but now I want to check the other areas, though. I like to get the most out of these events, chat.
Pain. The pain.
Mimic chest from Dark Souls?
Who goes there? Identify yourself.
Who are you? Fuckface.
No rain. Ah, the pain.
Wait, it's Ito again.
No rain? Oh, this is creeping my money out. Let's sneak by and stay out of sight. Have we reached the end? Paimon doesn't see anything here. Seems we went the wrong way. Let's try a different path.
That weird sound sounds like knocking and it terrifies me. Holy shit. Who the fuck is question mark, question mark, question mark? Is that the guy? Can I speak to him?
Oh no. You spotted me. Please, not a word of this to anyone. Otherwise, they'll dock my pay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
We should be safe here.
I want my 3 seconds back.
wait.
What the?
What's this?
Joy Mia?
It's Fire fireworks! Whew, I'm almost scared half to death!
Shouldn't we move out?
You and Mia, what the fuck was that all about, huh? What the hell is Yoi Mia? Okay, we gotta go back up this way. Poggies, we found it. Let's go. That was a dub.
That's the scent of dongo milk. We found it.
Sniffer.
Oh, it really is dongo milk. A lot of it, too.
Oh, that was cute.
And look, there's a scarecrow here. Now, who could have knocked it over? Ah, it's standing up.
Jesus Christ.
It's
only a trip to scare people. There's nothing to be scared of, Paimon.
Huh? Really? Whew. That almost scared Paimon's socks right off. Oh, looks like we managed to be the first ones here. With so much dongo milk, it wouldn't hurt if we drank a couple of bottles, right?
Hmm.
Is that permitted?
Everyone knows that dongo milk spoils quickly if it's left out. Besides, we should try some.
You drink some dango milk with Goro. Oh, no.
That's delicious. I'd like to buy some to bring back to Watatsumi Island.
Great.
I bet the troops would be happy to have such a good-tasting drink. It is unfortunate that it spoils easily.
Raiden?
Let's split the remaining bottles and start heading back. Ready?
I think I saw someone I know just now.
Oh, was it one of your friends? Do you need to go talk to them?
What the fuck?
In that case, I don't want to get in your way. I'll take back the remaining dongo milk. Maybe I'll run into you in the next Test of Courage round.
Holy shit.
Hey?
I didn't expect her to be here.
What are you doing here?
It's a tutorial segment.
Oh, hello. Miko told me about the Test of Courage event taking place here. I thought I would come and have a look.
Hmm.
So what do you think of the Test of Courage? Are you having fun?
It's more or less the same as I remember before. I wasn't scared by anything, but on the contrary, some of the event participants were horrified the moment they saw me.
Yeah, I bet.
Oh, that Miko. Did she send A here to scare people on purpose?
Certainly seems that way.
If that's the case, it feels like A isn't really experiencing the event like everyone else.
Yeah, it's kind of sad.
Oh, Paimon has an idea. We'll give you a bottle of the dongo milk we just found. That would make you a winner in this round, too.
True. Oh my god, we're giving her a free dub.
Ah, yes. Isn't that the dessert drink we had the last time we met? Sure, I'll take one.
The last time we met?
Actually, I've sensed a familiar feeling ever since I arrived here. It's brought some old memories to mind.
Huh.
Huh? A familiar feeling?
Have you been down to the beach by any chance?
No, not yet.
I was just strolling nearby when I noticed a space at the beach with a familiar game set up on it.
Chat, I remember the fucking date in Story Quest 1, but she literally said the last time we met. The last time we met, that wasn't that.
I took a brief look, and it appeared to be a game where you control flippers hovering in the air to strike a ball and hit some positioned elemental cubes.
Oh, is that out now?
I saw the game was called Akitsu Yugen. I'm guessing it originated from Akitsu Hazura. The thought of that game caused me to recall some things from the past.
Akitsu Hazura? What's that?
Huh.
It's a game where you use Hagoita to hit a ball towards a set target. It was once quite popular during festivals. Makoto also enjoyed playing Akitsu Hazura when she was alive.
Aww.
Yakiyako was still around at that time, and nights in Inazuma were much more lively than they are now. The yokai would hold festivals from time to time, gathering to drink, laugh, and play music.
Oh, does that mean you could eat the delicious festival food whenever you liked?
God damn it.
Yes. The yokai called their celebration the Mikawa Flower Festival. Makoto and I attended it once. She found it particularly fascinating.
That's cute.
Sadly,
and sad.
The past has all but vanished. But seeing a game like that again does make me feel happy.
Sounds like it could be fun! Paimon would like to play!
Damn,
dude. If you're interested, you can go to the beach and give it a try. It was still being set up when I was there earlier, but I assume it should be ready soon.
I'd be terrible with that game, by the way, Chant. I think I'd be terrible.
I shall return to Tenshukaku. Miko told me that the test of courage consists of 3 rounds. So please, keep up the effort and give it your best until the end. Considering you two, I think you should have no problem making it to the end.
I think we got this. I think we'll win every round.
Of course.
My game disappeared. Raiden oblivioned me. What the hell?
Paimon doesn't remember hearing anything about a game on the beach from Ayato.
Zhongli.
You think that activity is also planned by the Ashura Commission?
Yes.
Oh, the more Paimon thinks about it, the scarier it feels. Oh, this whole test of courage thing is keeping Paimon on edge. Anyway, the first round of the event should be finished by now, so let's head back.
I'm down. We'll head back and then we'll try the game, if it'll let us, that is. Wait, who was that? Was that Ito? Ito!
So, what'd you think? Do I know how to scare people or what?
Yes. You kinda do.
What Paimon think? Paimon was hiding behind you the entire time, so Paimon didn't really notice Ito scaring us at all.
Oh my god.
Paimon will leave this one to the Traveler. So, was Ito scary or not?
You're the scariest Oni ever.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Even I had no idea I possessed such talent. But this is just what I needed to hear. Now I'll show them. The gang will know just how terrifying their leader can be.
True.
Anyway, I've already figured out which path they'll be taking, so let's wait nearby and scare the pants off them. Now things are getting interesting. You ready? We've got people to scare.
I'm about it. I kind of do want to scare people. It'd be funny. Can I do it as Nahida? That'd be hilarious. What is this?
Shh, I think we're getting close.
Okay.
Come on. We can't let them see us.
Oh, this better be Yoimiya.
Here they come. So, how are you going to scare them, Ito?
Easy peasy. We'll wait for them to get real close, and then we'll jump out and shout together. They won't know what hit them.
I mean, true.
Huh? What are we, a bunch of kids now?
Kinda doubt this'll work.
Hey, don't underestimate me. It may sound simple, but I know exactly what'll scare them.
Yeah, okay.
The gang's probably moping along on their way back, saying things like, "This is boring," and "Let's go home." But it's dark and their guard is down. Now's our chance. Having the three of us suddenly come flying out of the bushes is gonna scare them real good.
I believe it. I think it could.
Before they come to their senses, we'll already be halfway to our next ambush spot.
Genius!
Shh, you hear that? Someone's coming. It must be them.
Oh god. Okay, I'm ready.
All right, I'll count us in. Ready?
Yeah.
We jump on 0. 3.
Oh,
two.
Paimon.
One.
You said on 0, idiot.
Ah!
Ooga booga booga!
Wait, you're not.
There! Ghosts!
Jesus Christ.
Ghosts.
Traveler's just vibing, dude. What?
Wait, hold on a second.
Oh, God, what is
Did
happening?
They were definitely not human.
They were wearing masks.
So all the strange rumors about the test of courage are true. Oh, what should we do? Do you think the ghosts are coming after us?
Yes, they're gonna murder us.
Paimon. I didn't expect you to be such a baby.
She's the floating lavender melon. Of course she's a baby.
Don't like to talk. You were the first to start running. Don't make fun of Paimon.
Well, you shouted ghost, so my instinct to escort you two to safety kicked in. After all, real ghosts are terrifying. My
yes.
skills are completely useless against them.
So why did we stop running?
Oh, because I just realized that they were also running from us.
Oh.
Which means they were afraid of us, too. And if that's the case, then there shouldn't be anything to worry about.
True.
Now that I've calmed down, I'm starting to wonder if they were actually ghosts. They might have been people dressed up as ghosts to scare us.
I agree. And yeah, I think Hu Tao and Ito with the same event would be absolutely hilarious, to be honest.
Oh, definitely not. No, during the event, I took a little walk around the Chinju Forest and saw all the gimmicks that the Yashiro Commission had set up.
How dare you?
Those three weren't from the Yashiro Commission, but they did seem a little familiar.
Wasn't it the kids Yoimiya looks after?
Let's go back there and take a look.
Huh? Now you want to go back?
That's what I thought.
There's still a chance that they were real spirits, right?
Yes.
If we go back now, they might try to eat us.
What?
Oh, it's all right, Paimon. If you're scared, you can stay here. Traveler and I will go investigate.
Really?
No.
Oh, that'd be great.
No, because if we are the same person technically on the event, if one of us doesn't take part, surely we lose. Wouldn't it be more dangerous to stay here alone?
Oh, right. The last mystery novel Paimon bought from Yai Publishing House had a plot just like that.
Well, that should
During
speak
the
volumes.
Whoever said I'm not going would always be the next victim.
Oh, well, you better go.
So, on second thought, Paimon's going with you. Don't you ever leave Paimon behind! Ever!
Jesus Christ.
It looked like they were running that way, but it's hard to say exactly where they went, so let's split up.
Let's split up and look for clues.
Then you'll be all alone, which according to the mystery novels is super dangerous!
Don't worry about me. Once my rear's in gear, I'm not afraid of nothing.
I disagree. I've seen you around beans.
Paimon has a bad feeling about this.
They scared you that bad, huh? Huh. Looks like they really do have a knack for spooking people.
Yeah.
This time, I'll capture him and learn their art for scaring people. Anyway, I'll catch you around.
Bro, it was literally just a mask.
Running off and talking to himself. Again. Oh, do we really have to go?
We better go have a look. Just sitting here won't accomplish anything.
Oh, fine. Let's go take a look then.
Okay.
But the second we see anything scary, we make a run for it. Got it?
No. That is not the test of courage. I think these are... I'm gonna say my prediction that these are the kids that Yoimiya was looking after, because Yoimiya was also pranking. Or at least there was fireworks, so I assume it was Yoimiya.
We've already walked all the way here. Wonder where those three went. Paimon didn't see them anywhere. Oh, maybe Ito was right. Maybe they've been hiding. Seems like they're not scary after all.
Yeah, crows, maybe Kujosara. Sounds like you've come to your senses.
Hey, listen up, you three little wimps. Paimon can already see you guys, so just come out and show yourselves.
Oh. Okay, wait a minute, because that was weird. What?
There's someone actually here. Paimon's scared again.
Why did that plant have, like, a constellation on it?
It's just gonna be a few more days.
Don't
do it, Chizuru. You can't give in to your desires. Others will suffer for it. You mustn't make the same mistake. Just hold on a little longer. You've already come all this way, right?
Yeah, Paimon, I can see. I'm looking at where you're pointing already.
Excuse us. Did you happen to see three rascals pass by here? Let Paimon tell you what they look like.
Is it me, or does it look like she's burying something? Oh, God.
Are you talking to me?
Yes, Flower Eye.
Someone like me?
Terrifying.
You have no business coming here. You shouldn't be anywhere near me.
Why?
If you value your lives, you must leave immediately. Otherwise, your souls will be trapped here forever.
So this is actually a good plan scare.
Now, away with you! Be gone!
Interesting. The air is permeated with strange fragrance of flowers,
wake
which
up.
Makes you
hey,
drowsy.
Trevor, wake up!
Wow, okay. What happened?
Thank goodness you're okay.
Hi, Hazel. The fuck are you doing here?
Before we get to that, I think someone needs your attention first.
Paimon? Wake up, Paimon. Wake up!
Are you here to rescue Paimon?
You don't need rescuing.
Hazel's here too! What happened to that scary person just now? Did you manage to defeat her?
Scary person?
There was a person wearing a weird outfit and who spoke strangely. We're not going to talk about all the magic shit that was going on?
Okay, I see. I only found the two of you passed out here when I arrived. There was no one else around.
Okay, that doesn't explain
it.
Tell me all the details. You tell Hazel everything that just happened. It didn't explain it.
As I suspected, there appears to be something more behind this test of courage event. But let's get back to your original question. I haven't told you the reason I'm here.
Colton, no problem.
The truth is, I was commissioned to come here for an investigation.
You were commissioned?
Okay.
That's right. Some time ago, a peculiar game was discovered on the beach.
A peculiar game on the beach? Oh, could it be the Yakitsu Yuken game that A mentioned?
Probably. Yeah, more than likely.
So you've heard of it?
Mm-hmm.
The game quietly appeared some time ago and has since attracted some players. Apparently, it's very interesting. There was no one on the beach other than visitors and tourists when the game appeared. Imagine it like this. A stall suddenly appears on the street with no owner.
Mm-hmm.
And stranger yet, it could operate normally without anyone supervising it. People at the beach can start the game simply by talking to the bulletin board.
Could it be run by ghosts?
Probably.
Some tourists started to say that, and the rumor began to spread, until it became a full-blown ghost story. The further that story spread, the more plausible it seemed, causing people to be unwilling to go anywhere near the beach.
Interesting.
The Tenryo Commission wanted to close the beach in order to investigate the situation and dispel the rumors, but before they could do anything, the Yashiro Commission organized the Test of Courage event here. People that were initially scared by the rumors began to believe that the beach game was actually a preview event planned by the Yashiro Commission for the Test of Courage, so visitors have gradually returned again. But I'm quite positive that the game never had anything to do with the Yashiro Commission.
Interesting.
Wait, so the Yashiro Commission were fully aware of all the spooky stuff going on, but they still decided to hold their event here?
Probably, because it brings attraction.
Yashiro must be one of the smartest guys we know. What the heck was he thinking?
I feel like it's because they know there's going to be a lot of people there anyway, right? And it's gonna go there. I feel like that is the smartest thing to do. You place your game or business where there's already a lot of people going in and out of. It's like asking why somebody would place a gumball machine in a mall. Well, because there's a shit ton of people there.
Who knows? But I'd rather trust tangible evidence than speculate on his thoughts. As for my commission, apparently someone reported that they found themselves trapped for hours on the beach while playing the game.
According
to his own account, he kept returning to the same location no matter which way he went. And even though his friends were nearby,
Samsara,
they couldn't see him.
It's a Samsara!
That sounds so scary!
Even though it was obvious that he wasn't telling me the whole story, the testimonies of his friends did validate that what he said actually occurred.
Interesting.
On top of that, it was also this very incident that led to all the ghost rumors. No one dared to go near the beach until the Yashiro Commission announced the Test of Courage. Who set up the game on the beach? And why did the Yashiro Commission help them cover it up?
Good question.
I need to uncover the truth, so I'm here to investigate. Anyway, don't mind me. Working together will only raise suspicion, so I'll undertake my own investigation for the time being. However, please proceed with caution. Based on my observations, most people are still unaware of anything happening here. Telling people that something's amiss might cause quite a stir.
Okay. This is getting interesting. I do... Oh, it's part one's done? Oh, God. Well, I guess the good thing is YouTube ain't even gonna know because it's gonna go straight into fucking part two.
3 days later.
I need to do this event. Holy shit. Day two. Shrine Maiden and Ito.
Hey,
are attacking Ito.
Finally made it.
Hell yeah, we did.
I was searching for hours. Still didn't see any sign of those three, so I decided to come back.
But why?
How about you? Find anything?
Poop.
Kinda hard to explain.
We never managed to fight those three either.
I see. So you came up empty-handed too.
Yes.
Well, it doesn't matter. I already came up with a new plan.
Oh!
Huh? What plan?
I'm nervous.
Shinobu told me a saying after she got back from studying in Liyue. It went something like, the something by day becomes, something by night?
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ, dude. The hunt by day becomes the hunted by night?
Yeah, that's what I said. Come on, keep up. Anyway, I was
okay,
so focused
dude.
On scaring people last round that those three dressed up as ghosts caught me completely off guard. But not this time. Oh, no. I'll be hiding nearby and waiting for those three to emerge first, and then I'll nail him with a surprise attack.
Didn't you literally try this last time?
Just playing it natural and join the contest. Got it? Okay, see you later.
Okay. We didn't even have a chance to rebuttal.
Wait,
fuck. He already tried that, dude.
He ran off again. Well, his plan does make some sense, at least. Let's go talk to the Shrine Maiden so we can join the second round.
Okay, Pog. Haunted Tales Part 2. Okay, let's do this shit. Let's do this. Talk to me.
Congratulations on winning the first round of the Test of Courage.
Hey, I did the mwahaha too, dude. We're so in sync. She just let me for real.
Now you're one step closer to the dark, messy truth.
Oh, God.
But is that really a good thing?
Oh, no.
Hey, cut the nonsense. What we just saw was super terrifying.
True.
Oh, really? Good to hear. Hearing the word super terrifying is exactly what all us event organizers would like to hear.
Oh, really?
No, that's not what Paima means. Something mysterious is also happening here, not just the event.
And what is that, Paima?
So what? You've heard the stories about the Test of Courage, haven't you?
Only a couple.
Everyone who participates in the event faces a variety of emotions. People are afraid of seeing their innermost fears appear before them. And yet they still seek the thrill of experiencing those fears.
It's like a roller coaster.
Isn't it natural for us to have things in the dark and deathly silent forest to help fulfill that experience?
Yes.
Just like the grinning monster standing behind you right now, waiting for you to turn around.
Oh, God. She's messing with you. There's nothing behind us.
I knew a little trick like that Toba! Would be enough to scare you off.
I see him.
Congrats on passing this test. The second round of the Test of Courage will begin shortly.
Who can we bring with us
have
this time?
Have you found your partner yet?
No, what? Let me go look for them.
But don't we already have a partner from the last round?
Yes, your team's outstanding efforts certainly won you the last round.
Yes, they did.
So it's understandable that you'd want to pair up with your previous partner. But unfortunately, you must find a different partner for each round of the event. If you don't have a partner by the time the next round begins, then...
Disqualification?
Yeah, Paimon already knows. If we don't have a partner in time, then we'll be disqualified.
Smudge, dude. I'm sad now.
Let's ask around and see if there's anyone looking Sayu, for a partner.
Toma, or Yoimiya? Okay, I feel like Yoimiya would be fucking great at this, dude. Sayu would just fall asleep. And Toma... I don't know. Toma's Toma, dude. Toma's fucking Toma.
Hey,
I don't
traveler?
Know.
Hey. I had a feeling you two would be here.
Oh, Yoimiya, you're here too?
Oh, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was also here for the first round, but I arrived a little early, so maybe that's why I didn't see you.
Maybe.
By the way, I heard you were the winners. Impressive. I eventually found the hidden dongle milk too, but it was already too late.
Actually, Paimon still doesn't know how we managed to find it. Paimon was just hiding behind him the whole time, and somehow we won.
Traveler, you never told me you were so good at this sort of event?
I'm incredible.
You were keeping it a secret, were you?
Yes, I was.
Anyway, would you like to pair up with me? We'd be an amazing team.
Together,
second round will be a piece of cake.
Holy booba, dude. Calm down, let me think about it.
Oh, I understand. You have to put some thought into choosing the best partner.
Why did
you... You did already win the first round, after all.
Why did you do like a 90-degree bend over? Holy...
Definitely no pushover when it comes to the Test of Courage. I've been to loads of these events.
Oh.
Besides, choosing me means you'll have one less tough competitor to deal with. Anyway, give it some thought.
Okay. Now, I'm going to pick based off of two things. She likes doing that. Yes, she does. She likes showing off, you know? Okay, I'm going to speak to everyone first and then give you my thoughts, chat.
Hey there. Congrats on winning the first round of the Test of Courage.
Thank you, Tomato.
Wait, were you also a contestant in the first round?
I sure was. But I couldn't shake this constant feeling that someone was secretly following me the entire round.
Probably Ayato.
He didn't seem to be from the Yashiro Commission. And I was concerned that he might be out to stir up trouble at the event, so I tried to capture him.
Huh?
I didn't expect him to run so fast. I gave chase for a while, but I couldn't keep up. And before I knew it, the round was over.
Oh, well, that's stupid. He distracted you.
He wasn't there to cause trouble. Maybe he was just trying to scare people.
Coming all the way to the Test of Courage to scare people? Well, I guess the world is full of all kinds of weirdos.
Oh, wait, it was Ito. it was Ito. He is a bit of a weirdo.
Anyway, shit. I'm gonna be sure to show everyone my abilities in the second round.
Yeah, I'm good. Oh, you sound a little bit liable.
I remember you once mentioned you like Kaidan.
Yeah, that's right.
Kaidan.
Once I really get into it, you might find me to be your toughest competitor.
Wait, what is Kaidan?
I'm only kidding, of course. I'm not here for the prizes, just to have fun. My lord has granted me a rare vacation, so I'd rather spend my time relaxing than worrying about some contest.
True. Oh, spooky story, okay.
Speaking of which, have you found a partner yet? Would you like to pair up with me?
You've literally just told me that you lost the first round because you went running after an Odie, and I'll think about it.
I understand. I hope you can find the right partner and win the second round.
Okay.
You've probably already heard that to win the Grand Narukami Shrine special prize, you have to win all three rounds.
Yes.
I'd like to know what the prize is as well, and you're the only one who has that chance now, so go for it.
Oh yeah, true. Nobody else could actually win it, eh? That's a good fucking point. Wait, I see a little fucking head, dude. Jesus.
You found me.
Yes, I did. That snore was so accurate, dude.
Are you here for the test of courage, too? Yes.
God fucking damn it.
She looks like she just woke up. Oh, nope. Wait, she's actually trying to fall asleep.
Oh, my God.
The test of courage is too scary, so I keep my eyes closed to not feel scared. But as soon as I close my eyes, it's really easy to fall asleep.
Yeah, tell me about it.
During the first round, a big bull-headed beast leaped out of nowhere and scared me half to death.
Oh,
so
Ushi.
I ran and hid behind a tree.
It's Ushi.
I closed my eyes and tried to hide for a while, but it was really dark and I fell asleep. By the time I woke up, the round was already over.
Oh.
A big bull-headed beast? Oh, wait, that sounds like Ushi.
Yeah, it does.
Now, no one wants to partner up with me for the second round.
Ah, the sympathy vote. Fuck.
Oh, poor Sayu. Wait, but why would you join the test of courage in the first place? Oh, because I heard that being frightened causes you to grow taller.
Huh?
What kind of silly idea is that? That's just a load of baloney.
Oh.
I wasn't sure if it was true either, but since I heard it could help people grow taller, I decided to give it a shot.
Oh, that's cute.
Well, Sayu doesn't have a partner yet. Should we team up with her?
Okay, so let me give you my reasonings here, chat. Listen, I don't really want to pick Toma. I kind of want to pick Yoimiya, but, and hear me out here, I feel like 99% of chat and everybody else is going to have picked Yoimiya. So I also kind of want to be different, and I do like Sayu and she's sleepy, and I think it'd be funny to pick Sayu. So I think I'm going to pick Sayu.
Really? You're willing to be my partner? Great! But please keep an eye on me, and don't let me fall asleep again.
I feel like if she gets scared, she's going to do a sonic roll, dude.
But I'm going to face my fears this time.
I feel like she's going to do a sonic roll out of there. Begin the second round of the test of courage.
You appear to have found a partner. Let's see if you can repeat your luck from the first round. Though, whether winning should be considered good luck or not is debatable.
What? What does that mean?
Anyway, I will now reveal the item you'll be searching for in the second round of the Test of Courage.
It's gonna be...
It's
a fan.
A fan.
A fan? You mean like the thing we use to keep cool when it's hot out?
Oh, not a fan.
Correct. The fan was personally selected by the Yashiro Commissioner himself and has been placed somewhere in the Chinju Forest. There will be signs to guide the way, but beware. The darkness that lurks in the forest is drawing nearer. Remember, if you can't go on any further, you can always give up and live to see another day.
We'll never give up.
Never. Never give up! Okay, Sayu, come with me. This way.
Hey, the sign is pointing this way.
Sayu, the sign is literally fucking pointed this way. What do you mean? Oh, God.
Something just fell from above. I'm out of here. Yoo-hoo, Art!
You...
Come on! We should get out of here, too!
Sayu! You big fucking dum-dum. Who the fuck?
I'm feeling a little sleepy.
Oh, great.
It's so dark here. It's hard to make out anything. So dim, that Paimon almost looks like a flying lavender melon.
What the fuck? It is a floating lavender melon.
That's not Paimon. It's
Kinda does, Paimon. Kinda does.
Paimon's over here! It's a lavender melon ghost!
Wait, where is Paimon? This isn't the right one, right? I don't want to get the right one instantly.
This
nice.
Isn't what we're looking for. Oh, and Paimon thought we had it too.
No.
Is it just Paimon? Or is there an eerie shadow over there?
What the?
You're right. Run!
No!
Wait for Paimon!
Don't run!
Please leave Paimon alone. Paimon doesn't taste very good.
Paimon, you're not even here.
Yeah, me neither.
Me neither.
Just leave us alone.
How the hell? I can't even attack. I wanted to see if it was in the bush.
I usually like to hide here and take a nap.
God damn it, Sayu.
Don't worry. There doesn't appear to be anything scary here. Whew, thank goodness. We finally made it to a safe spot.
Did those Tanuki statues just move?
Sayu? Was that statue always facing this way?
What the fuck is going on?
Why does Paimon have a feeling that it's staring right at us? What? That can't be right. This is supposed to be a safe place.
Well, it's not.
We have to hightail it out of here. Yoo-hoo Art, let's go.
Sayu, your Yoo-hoo Art clearly isn't fucking working, dude. Come on.
It's a dead end. We've been running for so long that Paimon's starting to get thirsty.
Take a watermelon.
Oh, look. There's a stall set up. Let's go buy something to drink.
I think it's a fucking dreadful idea.
Anyone here?
What is happening, dude?
Strange. There's nobody around.
Take a watermelon, then.
I don't know. This stall looks kind of spooky.
It's floating!
You're right. It's starting to creep Paimon out. Let's just get out of here. Another stall? It sure looks familiar.
What the fuck? Wait, what?
Wait, isn't this the same stall we saw earlier? Maybe it's following us.
What? That's not scary. What? Wait, that's the fan. Okay.
There sure are a lot of lanterns here.
No, I don't want to get the fan
are
yet.
Are you supposed to guide us?
Did I miss something?
I heard there are lanterns that release a chilly breeze to guide spirits to be reincarnated. Don't scare Paimon. Do we keep going?
We will keep going, but...
This is getting pretty creepy.
I want to make sure I'm finding everything.
I can't take it anymore. You go first.
All of the interactions.
I can hear your teeth chattering.
Yeah, yeah.
You must be really scared. I understand. I'm scared too.
I'm not scared.
What? Paimon's teeth aren't chattering.
Oh no, that's even scarier.
I heard a rattling sound. Was that not you?
Oh no, dude!
It's definitely not Paimon! Wait, it seems to be coming from inside the shrine!
Huh?
There's something over there!
Wait, fucking over where?
It's just a cat! Thank goodness!
I'm so done, dude. Jesus Christ. Okay, here we go. The fan!
Phew, this place should be safe. I can't believe I made it this far. Hey, did I get any taller?
Maybe a little.
Really? That's great.
Oh.
Enough about that. Look, isn't this the fan we're looking for?
I feel bad now. Oh, I didn't see the cat. True.
Painted on it, so it must be for some kind of festival.
Chat, it's not my fault I didn't see the cat when they're like, it's inside the shrine, and then they take 5 years for the fucking cat to even come out. I'm like, which fucking shrine, dude? There's like 10.
So does that mean the second round of the Test of Courage is over now? Yep, seems like it. Ha ha! We've won again!
We have won again. Great. Seems too easy.
Because I was just starting to feel sleepy.
Please don't pass out.
Wonder if Ito's still out trying to capture those three from earlier.
Oh god.
I'm a little worried about him. Why don't we have a look around? In that case, I'll take the fan back with me and have a little nap. Just don't stay out here too long.
Okay, that works.
I've got you now!
Just run! Don't worry about me!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Don't underestimate this, Oni. None of you are getting away today.
The children, Ito!
Hey, it's Ito! It looks like he captured captured those three we were looking for.
God fucking damn it.
Let's go see.
Wait, Tobit guided you to the cat because he gave it food? Oh my god. What mask is that? Is that a parrot mask? I can't see it properly.
Wow, Ito, you really captured them.
I kind of want a mask.
Seriously, why didn't you run when I told you?
That's cute.
What are you saying? We couldn't abandon you.
Hey, this is actually a really fucking cool mask. This one is funny. I like this one. It's like a cyclops.
Yeah, that's right. So just get on with it. If you're gonna eat us, then you'll have to deal with all three of us. We won't back down, even if we're already in your stomach.
Who said we were going to eat you?
We had eaten you.
Are you the ghost of something tasty?
Oh god.
And Ito, why are you so quiet all of a sudden?
She's thinking.
I have a weird feeling that I've seen these three somewhere before.
I'm pretty certain these three, the kids that Joy Bia looks after, isn't it?
I know. These are all creatures from the Ultimate Yokai Field Guide that Granny used to show me.
He means he's seen the fucking masks before.
There's Yoko, Kappa, and Hitotsume Kozo. They're all yokai.
It sure took you long enough to notice.
Well, we recognized Kappa. You right away. You're an Oni, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. He do be the
According
one and Oni.
To legends, Oni are grouchy, extremely strong, and crush other yokai into balls to eat them up.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. Who came up with that? Besides, you're the ones people are scared of, hiding behind bushes and scaring people off the road. What are you trying to do here? Don't think I didn't see you. Following him around and conjuring up all sorts of weird, scary stuff.
Yeah, I don't think that was them.
Aha! So it was you three.
Mm-mm.
No, we weren't trying to scare anyone. We were just trying to,
win the test of courage. Go ahead, you can tell us. Maybe we can help you.
Really? You're not mad?
A little bit.
Even though you scared the daylights out of Paimon a few times, it doesn't seem like you were doing it on purpose.
Oh, I think they definitely were.
Anyway, let's hear your side of the story, and Paimon will decide whether or not to forgive you.
Well, the truth is, we were planning a festival.
Huh?
One hosted by the yokai. But humans are also welcome to attend.
You mean the Mikawa Flower Festival?
Ah, the festival that A mentioned!
Oh.
Mikawa Flower Festival. Huh, that does ring a bell. Oh, right, it used to be hosted by the top yokai. I heard it was supposed to be a lot of fun. I mean, not as fun as my almighty Arataki Great and Glorious Drum-Along Festival, but still.
Yes, the Mikawa Flower Festival is our aspiration. But we know that our festival doesn't deserve that name.
Those are not masks, they are real yokai. Telling me these aren't kids wearing masks right now? I'll believe it when it shows me.
The times of Yakiyako are long gone. We're just a bunch of little yokai living in the wilderness.
Wait, they're actually yokai? Yes, Mahoyo didn't give them actual yokai models. I'm kind of sad. They're just in human form like Miko. I mean, I guess, but Miko's still got a fucking tail and ears. This is literally just kids wearing a mask. I would never know. I genuinely thought they were just kids.
As you can see, we lack the necessary yokai powers to put on such a grand festival.
Are we sure?
But we're determined to still reach out to humans and express our gratitude.
Huh? Gratitude? What do you mean?
Mm-hmm. You see, we live in the wilderness and are frequently attacked by monsters. They would come and stir up trouble on our land, forcing us to hand over our food. Sometimes they would even get rough and leave us injured.
Aww.
But later, many human adventurers came into the wilderness and drove off the monsters, allowing us to live in peace.
I get it now. You want to repay the favor, but your powers are too puny. Hey, don't let it get to you. You might be a bunch of pipsqueaks, but you're all solid yokai in my book.
Oh, that's cute.
So, are you the ones who set up the Akitsu-Yugen game on the beach?
Yep, that was us. Have you tried it yet? Isn't it fun? We drew inspiration from the legendary Akitsuhazura. It took a lot of yokai power to set it up.
Hanasobi.
After that, we didn't have much yokai power left, so we set up some stalls in the forest to add to the festival atmosphere.
We were just following you to see your reactions.
Is the Akitsuhazura really that important? Why did you spend all of your yokai power to build it?
What is that?
Paimon would have taken the traveler for a big meal if you had set up more food stalls.
There were food stalls.
Really?
We just run away from them because they were haunted.
We've never met a human before, so we had no idea what you would like.
Wow, so these...
We focused on building the Akitsu Yugen because of a legend we heard.
That's crazy, dude. I didn't think they were actually yokai. That's wild. Is this the first time we're meeting a...
It's the story of yokai meeting a human during a festival hundreds of years ago.
Hmm. Other than yai.
It's said that long ago, a human samurai once stumbled across the Mikawa Flower Festival.
Huh? Oh.
What's a human doing here?
Yo.
We erected the barrier, didn't we? Ugh, what a pain.
Isn't that...
The yokai at the festival began discussing how to drive away the human. Huh? When suddenly, they heard a voice.
This is our festival, and the point is to have fun. What difference does it make if a human joins us yokai?
Octopus.
The speaker appeared to be a prominent figure among the yokai.
Wait, this looks sick.
The other yokai fell silent.
You there, young man. Do you drink sake?
Yes, I do.
Then join us. We can enjoy tonight's festivities together.
Another British dude.
And so,
let's go.
Yokai and samurai celebrated together. The two competed in the highlight of the festival, the Akitsu Hazara. Their spectacular game ended in a draw, and a new friendship was forged.
I can't believe a human could keep up with me.
Witnessing the dynamic powers of the yokai will certainly help hone my swordsmanship.
You're a swordsman?
Yes, I'm currently traveling the world in search of formidable opponents.
Then let's make a deal. We meet for a duel every 10 years. What do you say?
Pretty good deal.
I look forward to it.
Pretty good deal.
The Flower Festival is meant to bring happiness to all who attend, and Akitsu
Hazara
is a symbol of friendship.
That was super cute.
When we decided to hold the festival here, setting up Akitsu Hazara was our first priority. Unfortunately, the real Akitsu Hazara has been lost to time.
Aww.
What we created is a version of the game we heard about from a wandering merchant, so we changed the name to Akitsu Yugen.
Okay, fair, interesting. We heard that someone had been trapped in Akitsu Yugen.
Yeah, but that wasn't us.
Oh?
We have no idea what could have gone wrong.
We closed Akitsu Yugen a while ago and carefully checked it for any issues. But we didn't find anything wrong with it. Maybe it was just some strange mishap caused by our unstable yokai power at the time.
Possibly.
They don't look like they're lying. And believe me, I know a liar when I see one. Maybe it really was just an accident.
After that incident, people stopped coming to the attraction.
I'm not surprised, to be fair.
A human man with blue hair appeared and walked around the area.
Ayato!
He had a piercing gaze. I almost felt like he could see us.
Maybe?
But then he turned and quickly left without saying anything.
It wasn't long before large numbers of people began coming to the Chinju Forest. And visitors were playing Akitsu Yugen again. It was wonderful.
A human man with blue hair?
It's gotta be Ayato. Yeah.
Now that you mention it, the fan that Ayato chose is the same kind that's used at a festival. Do you think that he knew about the yokai when he decided to hold the test of courage here?
That's very smart if he did.
My bro Ayato is here for the test of courage too?
My bro...
maybe he's here to catch Oni Kabuto. Ha! Had I known that, I would have brought the one I caught a few days ago to battle him.
Oh god.
Wow! Ito's still clueless about who Ayato really is.
It's alright, no need to tell him for now. Just let him keep believing it's just a bro, you know? Just
anyway.
Any other bro.
Seems like all the strange things we saw earlier were caused by these little yokai.
Bro, when he finds out, holy shit.
What a relief.
He's gonna flip.
What's happening? The test of courage doesn't seem that scary after all.
True.
Hey, you want to hang out with humans, right? I totally get that.
Yeah.
After all, we yokai are becoming a rare breed these days. If all we do is isolate, we'll only feel more lonely. So why don't you let this Oni do you a favor, See, I'm a yokai too, right? And I'm already a natural in human society.
Oh, I guess true.
I bet there's not a single person in Inazuma who hasn't heard of Arataki, the one and only Ito.
Honestly?
Come on, let's go. I'll show you around.
He's not wrong. He's not wrong, to be fair.
Now that Paimon doesn't feel so scared anymore, maybe we can walk around the area. The yokai said they wanted to host a festival. evil, but Paimon was too busy having the bejeebers scared out of her to pay any attention until now. Come to think of it, Paimon remembers seeing some festival-related items on the beach. Let's head over there and take a look. Maybe
Hell yeah.
we can help out.
Wait, why are y'all saying who, chat? Who? What? Raiden's voice line about Ito is just who? No. No. What the fuck is his about her? Jesus Christ, dude. The voice lines are too good. Holy. It's her! Best NPC.
Wait, you're the strange lady we met before.
Dude, she's so cool.
Oh, it's you two again.
Yes, it is.
I have to say, I'm impressed by your willingness to approach me after last time. You're much braver than I thought.
Are you a yokai too?
I'm not going to let you off the hook so easily this time. If you don't leave, I'll...
Go on, you'll...
Nice try, but you don't scare us anymore.
Uh-oh.
We just met your fellow yokai and they told us everything.
Oh no.
Huh? Fellow yokai?
Uh-oh.
That's right. You're another little yokai who lives in the wilderness, aren't you? We just met Yoko, Kappa, and Hitotsume Kozo.
Uh-huh.
So which type of yokai are you, Oh, let Paimon guess. Actually, Paimon has no idea what you are.
Yeah, no.
Anyway,
be,
it doesn't matter.
Be
We're
the...
on our way to play Akitsu-Yugen. Care to join us?
Akitsu-Yugen? Again, that game. How could this be happening now? All I needed was a little more time, and I could...
She does sound different now. She sounds older.
What's the matter? Are you not feeling well? Oh, maybe you're hungry, or maybe you didn't sleep well.
You good?
You look pretty exhausted. Don't worry. Ito has already taken your fellow yokai to meet some new friends. Everyone will get along just fine.
Ito's showing some of his better qualities this time. We are friends too.
Yeah, so there's no need to worry. Come on, let's go play Akitsu-Yugen.
Dude, her eyes are so cool.
We'll see who can finish the game the quickest. The loser will have to grant the winner a wish.
Oh.
Oh, it's starting. Get ready.
Interesting. Okay. Wait, so we have to play these? Pew, pew, pew. We did it. Pog. Yeah, Hydro do be kind of Pog. Water pulse will stick to Ice Bar so you can relaunch them.
You cleared all the elemental cubes so quickly.
True. Kind of Giga Chad.
Everyone thinks we got this in the bag. All right, it's your turn.
Okay. Watch and learn.
Okay. Dude, the voice is so different. Cheetah.
Paimon's head is spinning after watching that.
She's cheating.
Did you see how she did it?
She cheated. I concede, you win.
Even if the rules have changed a little, I would never lose to amateurs like you.
What the fuck?
Oh, right, you're a yokai. You're the ones who created Akitsu-Yugen.
I don't like it now.
No wonder you're so good. Anyway, we'll keep our word. You can make a wish now.
Wish for Yelan.
We won't do anything that's clearly impossible or harmful to others.
Okay.
A wish, huh? Then I wish...
Yeah?
That we never cross paths again.
Aw.
Wait. What? But didn't we just have a great time together?
That's precisely why.
Huh?
Don't ever come near me or speak to me again.
Don't speak to me or my children ever again.
Surely that's a wish you can fulfill, right?
Yeah, fuck you then, bye.
This is my final word of warning. If I ever see your faces again, I will... I'll steal your souls!
You're so...
Scared now? Good! Then don't come here again!
You sound so convincing. Yeah.
Paimon doesn't get it. Did we do something wrong?
Everyone has their reasons.
Fair enough. But Paimon had a lot of fun playing Akitsu-Yugen with her. could see her again.
Yeah, well, anyway, she doesn't want
us
to.
Let's see how Ito's doing.
Okay, oh, look, the poster of the two people from the thing, chat. I just noticed that. Look at this. Oh, that's cute.
So, you must be Hitatsume Kozo.
Yes, it is. Yeah, I'm scared of Yuimiya.
No need to be nervous. I'm Yuimiya, and I run Naganohara Fireworks.
Pog?
Oh, I once saw some Naganohara fireworks. Even though I was watching from a distance, they were still so beautiful, bursting across the sky.
Yeah, fireworks would be pretty great.
Then the next time we meet, I'll bring some fireworks for us to launch together. Ooh. That'll be fun.
Whoa, really? Thank you very much. And if I may ask, are you Lord Kaedehara Kazuha?
How was everybody spamming Kazuha? I didn't even see him. Oh my fucking god. Hi, Kazuha.
Yes, that's me. But I'm afraid that I'm no lord. Just a wandering samurai.
I've seen you with your sword in the wilderness. You made quick work of many opponents with your amazing swordsmanship.
Interesting.
That must have been when I was trying to escape Inazuma. It wasn't as impressive as you make it seem. I had to face many trying situations before I was able to leave the island.
Okay, it wasn't that impressive. The Musou no Hitotai? Oh, you know, it's just another Sunday, you know?
The head of the Kamisato clan also lent me his assistance at the time. By the way, this is his sister.
Goro's back.
So, you must be the one and only Shirasagi Himegimi. What an honor.
Hell yeah.
There's no need to be so formal.
Okay.
I never imagined I'd ever meet someone as distinguished as you. I must be dreaming.
Then Goro.
Hey, don't you want to go talk to them too?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm rather shy.
Is that a shell on its back or a backpack?
That's strange. You seemed completely fine when we were chatting.
I'm not sure why. But I feel so relaxed when talking with you, General Goro.
Aw, that's cute. That's cute.
Actually, I'm the most timid of the three of us.
It's a shell.
I hid for days the last time someone tossed a stone into the river. Sorry for rambling on. It's odd. I'm not normally like this.
Why did he scream?
It's okay. You can't excel at everything. The important thing is to have the courage to change.
Hey there. Chatting away, I see.
Oh my god, the whole gang's here. Holy.
I've never seen a kappa before.
Interesting.
Hello there.
Thank you for bringing so many amazing people to meet us, Ito.
This is a lot of people together all at once.
It's nothing. Being the one and only means being the best, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, I should mention that I even have my own gang, and every member has a special title.
True. Floating lava in a melon.
Classic Ito. There you go, bragging about yourself again.
Okay, dude, come on.
Them. Everyone's here for the test of courage, not because you brought them here. Half the people here don't even know who you are.
Hey, this is
That's
my
so
moment.
Sad.
Don't ruin it for me.
Ito really isn't as cool as he claims to be. When it comes to having connections in Inazuma, nobody can beat Paimon and the Traveler.
So rude.
Oh, yeah? All right. Well, then let's have a little contest and see who knows the most people.
Sure. Bring it on, Bull Checker Beetle Boy.
Please don't fight. Actually, I think you're both really amazing.
Bull Checker
and
Beetle
you also
Boy.
Have a great friendship, just like Lord Kamai and the Samurai.
Well, of course. Boss! Oh, it's the boys!
Ah, oh, shit.
I was so caught up with the yokai that I forgot I was supposed to scare the daylights out of the gang. Boss!
What?
Hey, fellas. Look, I can explain.
Boss, we're sorry.
Huh?
Wait, what now?
What the hell happened?
We shouldn't have ever doubted you, boss. You were right.
Yeah, the test of courage is terrifying. There are definitely ghosts here.
Oh, easy.
I still get shivers just thinking about it. But the thrill was kind of fun.
What?
Oh,
what is going on?
Well, I told you it would be an exhilarating experience, but no, none of you believed me. Anyway, no need to be too scared now. Let me tell you what's happening here. It turns out there aren't any ghosts here. All the scary stuff you saw was just a little misunderstanding we had with the yokai.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yes, the yokai that is a...
Sorry, but I've never seen these three before.
It's probably
sure
the woman.
What you've seen, but I don't think it had anything to do with us.
Huh?
Huh?
Wait, hold on, little Yoko. You're kidding, right? You know, now's not really the time for that.
No, I'm serious. I really don't know what's going on.
It's probably the woman.
But if it wasn't you guys, does that mean there are real ghosts out here?
Wait a minute, we did meet some lady who was all dressed up.
Oh, that's right. Paimon assumed she was a yokai too.
Muzan,
but
yeah.
We even played a Kitsuyuken with her.
I'm not sure who it was you met, but we're the only three yokai who wanted to hold a festival here.
Interesting. Ooh, maybe it's the... did they take...
Boss, save us!
No, I don't know.
Calm down. Everyone, just calm down now.
What's all the noise about?
Hazel?
Oh, you're the Tenryo Commission's...
My man, okay.
There's nothing to fear. Even if there really is a ghost, only your noise would drive it away. Ito, you and your gang should go and inform the other contestants about the situation. Traveler, Paimon, please, come with me.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Paimon somehow feels a little better now that Hazo's here.
Yeah, a little bit. Hazo knows how to handle business. Wait, I can talk to these. Let me talk to Ito.
Don't freak out, boys. Whatever happens, I'll protect you.
You're the best, boss!
Oh, God, yes. Ah, the protection of Ito. Just what we want.
Recite this to yourself. Keep your mind clear and at peace. Free your thoughts from spirits and ghosts.
Who wrote that?
Those were Her Excellency's remarks in the directive. She once said,
Coco?
There's nothing to be afraid of as long as your conscience is clear. Oh, if only Her Excellency were here. She would get to the bottom of all this in no time.
I'm not being funny, Goro, but if my conscience is crystal clear and there's a fucking ghost stood in front of me, I'm gonna be still pretty fucking scared, I'm not gonna lie.
Could the rumors be true then? Do strange phenomena really happen every time the test of courage is held?
Probably.
Please be careful.
Okay. I assume we get to pick anyone for the D3 thing. Situation.
He has my absolute trust, but given Lady Ayaka is still here, we must get to the bottom of this as soon as possible.
Is there really a ghost around here? I'm gonna go look for it. I've never seen a ghost before. Oh, how exciting!
Jesus Christ. Did I ever do Thomas Hangout? No. No, I haven't done Thomas Hangout yet.
This is one of my usual hiding spots. It's always safe here. Let me show you a trick. Just cover your eyes, and the scary things will go away.
That's not how it works, but sure. You should do Thomas Hangout, Madge. No, never. Not anymore.
Unease pervades the air, and fear is spreading. Maybe this is the real test of courage. It's already becoming an unforgettable experience for me.
Wait, she's gone. What if the Shrine Maiden is the yokai?
Strange. She isn't here.
Or she's just going to try and scare us.
What's this? Look, there's something written in red on the bulletin board.
Huh?
Round 3, item, Hagoita.
The hell is a Hagoita?
Does this mean that the item we have to find in the third round is a Hagoita?
The Shrine Maiden appears to be urging us to finish the third round of the Test of Courage.
But where did she go? Has she been taken away by a ghost?
Next?
Paimon will never leave your side now!
Interesting.
The words are scribbled hastily, but there's no evidence of a struggle. However, aren't there too many words written here?
What did you notice, Hazel?
I believe that the three items chosen for this three-round contest were each selected by the three organizing parties. The Dongo Milk was chosen by the merchant who funded the event,
and the fan was chosen by the Yashiro Commission, which
provided
the stamp. So, does the Hagoita, which should have been chosen by the Grand Narukami Shrine, have any unique significance?
Let's worry about that later. The bigger question is, are we really going to join the third round of the Test of Courage? Paimon would love to win the grand prize, but our safety comes first!
Our safety hasn't been... an issue.
Make a tactical retreat.
Oh, Bybod, stop it. We fucking got this shit.
My commission to complete, so I'll stay. Fear arises from mystery, and it's a detective's job to unearth the truth from the mystery.
True, Hazel.
Paimon somehow feels a little better after hearing you say that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have been up against far worse.
Let's wait for a while.
Okay.
Maybe the Shrine Maiden had something to take care of and we'll be back soon.
Yeah, sure. Let's have a look. Oh, is that day two over? God damn it. Okay, part two done. Part three coming right up. Paimon's just that kid that easily scared by horror films. Honestly true. I can't blame her either. Horror films do be kind of scary to a lot of people.
Traveler.
Hi.
Paimon. Please let me be your partner for the final round of the Test of Courage.
You're so needy. I'm kidding. Yeah, fine.
I'd like your assistance with this investigation, since you two are the only ones who have seen the alleged ghost.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine with Paimon. What do you think, Traveler?
Fine by me. Do you have any ideas so far, Hazel?
I have a few theories, but we don't have enough leads yet.
Interesting.
There are some places I'd like to investigate first, so you two can accompany me.
Okay.
Sure. Where would you like to start?
I want to go back to where we first met up. According to your accounts, you encountered the ghost there and passed out. I believe may still be some clues there.
Okay.
Do we really have to go there? What if we're walking into a trap?
Are you worried that she'll be waiting for us? If anything, that would make things easier. My worry is that we won't be able to find her. Honestly, it'd save me a lot of trouble if she were to show up on her own.
Wow, Hazel, you're fearless.
I was thinking, what if it's the
you see, the less afraid creature. Let's go.
The creature that we saw in the cutscene, but that sounded, the voice was totally different. I mean, the voice was like a dude's voice, right? And that's a chick, so I don't know if, can the human form of a yokai be like completely sounding different to the yokai? I don't know. Could Yai's fox form speak? Very interesting.
This should be approximately where you first encountered the ghost.
Yes.
Of course, we cannot conclude whether the woman is actually a ghost or not at this point, but I'd like to go over everything that happened again. Do you recall anything she said at the time?
Personally, no, but these guys might. Yep.
She warned us not to go near her, and she said if we didn't leave, our souls would become trapped here.
Which is bullshit, dude.
Paimon doesn't want to remember that moment. Paimon's shivering just thinking about it.
That sound, dude. Ooh.
And then what happened?
Then everything seemed to get darker, and Paimon started to feel dizzy. There were ghostly flames flickering all around, and...
yeah, it was kind of spooky.
Some sort of black mist surrounding the ghost, and then Paimon passed out.
Mm-hmm. Pretty spooky, pretty spooky.
Based on your account, it does really seem like you've seen a ghost.
Exactly! So are you convinced it was a ghost now?
It's possible, but I'm more interested in what she's actually trying to achieve than what she is. Even if she is a ghost, as long as she possesses some sense of reason, then there must be some purpose behind her actions.
Wasn't she after our souls? She said that herself.
Fetch me their souls!
I think she was just trying to scare you.
Yeah, probably.
Oh.
Shrine Maiden.
You think so?
Dude, I bet it is the Shrine Maiden.
If I had the ability to take your souls, then why go to the trouble of warning you over and over again? Besides, a ghost wouldn't have allowed you to walk away knowing about the secret of its powers.
That does make sense.
I mean, the kids did, though. It's not a ghost, I guess. Because you were always too scared to think straight.
I believe there are only two possibilities. The first is that she wanted to reap your souls, but there was some condition that had to be met. You know, like what we usually call a curse.
There's no way.
But if you had really been cursed, then you would probably have noticed it by now.
Mm-hmm.
So, this is the less likely scenario. I believe she was just trying to scare you away.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, why would she want to scare us away? Oh, Paimon knows!
Uh-huh.
Maybe she was trying to get us to quit so she could claim the Test of Courage prizes!
Was she registered as a contestant?
Oh! Probably not. So why does she want to scare us?
Oh!
Do you have any ideas, Hazel?
I bet it's someone to do with the Narukami Shrine, or it's the Shrine Maiden because they don't want us to win the grand prize for winning all three rounds.
Based solely on your account, I don't believe she actually meant any harm. She just didn't want you to stay here.
I don't think she wants us to win
but
all three.
This evidence alone is insufficient to make any valid assumptions. She could very well be guarding some treasure or covering up a crime. Though, my intuition is telling me that neither of these hypotheses are correct. Let's continue investigating the surrounding area.
Okay. Collect clues. There are some footprints visible on the ground. Upon closer inspection, they seem to belong to Hazel and myself. Jesus Christ. Looked all around but haven't found any clues. Look it up, there are a few branches that are slightly bent downwards as if something heavy has been hanging from them. Interesting. Okay. Not much then.
Have you found any leads yet?
Just noticed some branches that seemed a little unusual.
Yeah, some tree branches seem like they were bent by something, but that's about it.
Yeah, not much.
I see. After you left, I took a good look around the area.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from the bent branches, there are burn marks in some places, but that doesn't really tell us much.
Interesting.
If only there was some more conclusive evidence.
Excuse me. Sorry to interrupt.
It's okay. The yokai children.
Oh, it's you guys! What are you all doing here?
We heard you were out searching for clues, and we wanted to help.
Oh, that's really brave of you.
Actually, we're also really unsure about what's happening here. We just asked the members of Mr. Ito's gang about what happened to them, and it sounded really scary. That lady is either a nasty, evil spirit, or formidable yokai.
I think it's more so the yokai.
It's not good. But we still want to hold the Mikawa Flower Festival.
But.
Uh-huh.
We long admired the friendship between Lord Kamai and the samurai. Which is why we want to hold the Mikawa Flower Festival, to return the favor we once received from the humans. Even though our powers are limited, we don't want this bond of friendship to vanish. The Mikawa Flower Festival is
dude, this is so cute. That's cute.
The Jinju Forest covers a large area, so it'd be great to have more help in the investigation. Welcome to the team. Let's all do our best to figure out what's going on.
Don't worry, we're very familiar with the area. We won't miss any clues.
Investigate the little yokai's findings. Okay. Let's have a look. Huh? Are you good, Kappa?
Look what I found down by the river.
What did you find? What is it? Show me.
Huh? What is it?
Oh my god, show me! I'm impatient.
Is it a scrap of black cloth? I've never seen fabric like this before.
Show me.
This is a piece of shade cloth.
Jesus Christ.
Shade cloth?
Yeah. It can effectively block out light and is used in a variety of settings, but including stage performances.
This could easily be the Shrine Maiden.
There's a rough tear in the cloth, probably caused by a sharp stone, or maybe some branches.
Branches?
Suppose that a large shade cloth was originally hung from a tree, bending the branches. When the shade cloth was removed from the tree, perhaps one of the corners caught and the branches ripped it, causing a small piece of black cloth to fall into the river.
True.
Either she didn't care, or she was in too great a hurry. Perhaps she had other things to handle at the time.
But why would she hang shade cloth in the trees?
I'm only speculating, but maybe she used it to create the atmosphere you experienced.
What do you mean?
Let's not worry about that for now. There's still many variables I haven't deduced yet. Next, I'd like to investigate the place where the Arataki gang encountered her. Do you know how to get there?
Oh, I know the way.
I'm pretty sure I remember too.
I asked the gang members where their encounter with a ghost happened when we were chatting earlier. I'll take you there.
Good. Please lead the way. Let's go find out what's going on.
Okay, let's go. Let's do it. Let us do it. Wait, is it actually right here? Jesus Christ.
This is the place.
My God. It was 3 meters away.
They claimed that as they passed through here, the area suddenly grew dark and some ghostly flames appeared out of nowhere.
What a coincidence.
Yeah, very similar setting.
We saw the very same thing.
Let's start by taking a look around the area, just as we did before.
Okay. Look for clues, but it's just talk to the yokai. Okay.
I found some sort of smashed ball under the tree.
A pokeball.
Inside of it looks like it was blackened by smoke, and it smells like fireworks.
Never mind. Not a pokeball. It's a firework.
Judging from the burn marks left on the scene, the ghostly flames you saw were not created by yokai power. Rather, they appear to have been caused by something flammable. I'm not sure what, though.
Yoimiya wouldn't have done this. Nah, I don't think. Nah, it's definitely not Yoimiya.
There's powder in the cracks of these stones. I picked some up and sniffed it to see what it is, and it made me really dizzy. Ugh. I'm so tired now.
Jesus fucking Christ, dude. Kids, everything needs a fucking choking or do not press hazard or something stupid. It's like, I found this weird thing with a trigger, so I pulled it to see what it did, and I accidentally shot a fucking squirrel. No! Stop sniffing and playing with things that you don't know what it fucking is. It's dangerous as shit, Kappa. Ay-ay-ay. I mean, this seems like firework stuff, but I don't think it'd be Yoimiya, and the woman's definitely not Yoimiya, I don't think. I don't know. Weird.
Similar scare tactics, and she didn't have the time to completely hide the traces.
True.
I believe we're closing in on the truth now.
Oh yeah?
I'm almost certain that the woman you encountered was not a ghost.
I agree.
She possesses no extraordinary powers. She was merely scaring people with some small props she had set up ahead of time.
Yeah.
Some small props? But can you really do all that with just some props? What we saw was absolutely terrifying.
First and foremost, the test of courage contributed to the unsettling atmosphere here. You were initially frightened by your first encounter with these three yokai, and then shortly after, you ran into the mysterious woman.
Mm-hmm.
It was natural for you to be on edge. Because you were already tensed up, you were breathing more rapidly and inhaled a lot of sleeping powder that she had sprinkled around the area.
Makes sense.
This is what caused you to feel dizzy. That's when she pulled down the shade cloth and lit those so-called ghostly flames, creating a terrifying scene.
I think it's a shrine maiden.
Explanation anyway.
So, it was all just a show?
Apparently.
She tricked us!
She did a very good job.
There is, however, still one loose end. The person who commissioned my investigation did become stranded on the beach as a result of some unusual
power. That's who's trapped.
That couldn't have been accomplished by just a few small props. But if she possesses such powers, why bother with the theatrics?
Good point.
Paimon can't wrap her head around all this.
It is pretty confusing. Use those brain cells,
she
Hazel.
She can only use props to scare people in the forest, but she can use strange powers on the beach. Huh. I see. I think I've figured it out.
She's a summer ghost.
That was fast.
What the fuck does that
mean? If we rule out the potential of organized crime, then only one possibility remains. Mm-hmm. I know who the woman is. Let's go to the beach.
Let's go to the beach? Beach?
What? We'll come along too.
No. You should go back and tell the others not to be afraid and not waste their time searching the forest. The truth has surfaced. It's time to put an end to all the unnecessary panic and await the outcome of the test of courage.
Okay, but please be careful. If you run into any danger, simply call out our names. We'll be able to hear you.
There shouldn't be any danger now.
Bruh.
But thank you anyway.
Other than the Shrine Maiden, I don't know who the fuck this could be. Unless it's someone totally
Let's
new.
Let's search along the cliffside. If I'm not mistaken, there should be a chunk of earth that's unlike the others.
Which I guess it could be. Wait, what? This looks exactly the same as all the rest. What is this? What are we doing?
I knew it. I knew that you would come find me here.
Who are you?
There she is. Paimon Everyone thought you were a yokai like the others, but they said they'd never seen you before. So, who are you? And why did you try to scare us?
Come on.
I have already warned you never to speak to me. If you don't leave now, then...
I'll set up the stage lights and, God help you, I will drop a sandbag down to make the ghost appear from nowhere. The fuck? I'm not scared?
She's terrifying! Hazel, it sure doesn't seem like she's using any props this time!
Don't move. Just trust me. Mm. Your yokai power won't scare us. It will only hasten your demise.
Yokai power?
Maybe this is the fox person for the event.
Huh? How did you know?
You're a yokai that emerged from an object and assumed a human form outside of your own body. When this type of yokai is close to its own body,
oh,
it can use some yokai power, but that ability weakens as it moves further away.
Yo, that's cool as fuck. What? Wait, that's actually kind of sick.
And if the original body is destroyed, then the yokai that originated from it will likewise perish.
Oh, and that's
Should
the
I refer
body.
To you as a Hagoita spirit or Tsukumogami?
Don't bother. You may call me Hanyuda Chizuru.
Wait.
That is the name I go by now.
Chizuru, why do you want us to leave? If you're a yokai, you should understand why the other yokai want to interact with humans. Besides, we had a great time playing a Kitsuyu game together, didn't we? Just like the story of Kamai and the samurai.
Damn it, it's not that person. God damn it.
Yes. That's why.
That's why what? I was wrong.
That's why I don't want you to be sad too.
Sad?
What?
What do you mean?
I'm sure the yokai have already told you of the story about Kamai befriending the samurai. But they don't actually know the entire story.
Huh. Wait, oh, it's different?
The samurai was about 25 years old when they met at the festival. They met again 10 years later and remained friends. They spent time together drinking, traveling, and sparring. When they had first met,
Jesus.
They merely respected each other. But 10 years later, they became best friends.
Dude, that's cool
as fuck. After another decade, the samurai had reached the pinnacle of his swordsmanship and won their duel by a narrow margin.
Ooh, he had like a bowl
Kamai
eye.
Was so astonished by his defeat, he gave up drinking and began training to become stronger for their next duel.
Nice.
However, another 10 years later, Kamai did not meet the samurai. As it turned out, war had broken out in the south, and the samurai had gone to defend the border.
Ooh.
Kamai was unconcerned, because 10 years was nothing in a yokai's lifetime.
Oh.
But when they met once again, Kamai discovered that the samurai was already 65 years old. He couldn't believe his eyes when he saw the samurai's gray hair and scars covering his body.
He still looks sick.
Hey, old friend. Can you still wield the sword?
Oh,
I'm getting too old to fight. This time, I've come to say goodbye.
Oh.
I see. Then, how about one last game of Akitsu Hazara?
All right.
The samurai gave his best effort during the game.
I wonder if that's who's
trapped.
He had to quit
halfway through because he was too weak.
Oh, man.
After putting down his Hagoita, Kamai remained silent for a long time before letting out a long sigh.
What a shame.
Yo, I wished I looked like that when I'm 65.
It started as something they looked forward to, and in just a few decades it turned into regret. Lord Kamai's appearance hadn't changed, but his dear friend in front of him had grown old. The joys of friendship gradually gave way to the pain of regret.
Aww, people often that's sad.
That those outside the situation can see things more clearly. And I learned a harsh
Crab.
Truth after witnessing all of it. Everything that people come to regret is inevitably set in motion from the beginning. We yokai are different from humans. We have longer lifespans and different natures, but we share the same world. We interact with one another. We are drawn to one another, and will eventually part ways.
Man.
When the dream ends, all that is left are sorrowful memories and lingering pain.
So I wonder if that's why she wanted us to basically piss off and not speak to her again, because she didn't want to get attached, because she would just outlive us. Even though we're 500 years old, she probably didn't know that.
Even a wise and seasoned yokai like Kamai felt sadness when it was time to say goodbye.
Aww.
Imagine what a pure and kind little yokai would feel.
Oh.
Sag.
So, you mean...
Very sad.
I was hiding on this beach, waiting for the last of my days. But those three yokai came and set up the Akitsuyugin here, which woke me from my slumber. I didn't want them to approach humans with unbridled optimism and enthusiasm just because they'd heard the legend of Kamai and the samurai. That would simply be repeating the same mistake.
Oh, man.
Is that why you pretended to be a ghost? To scare all the people away from here? Oh, so you must be the one who trapped that guy on the beach. That was a little bit harsh, don't you think?
It depends on why.
My power has become pretty weak now. And most of the time I just use some props I've collected to scare people. I can't show myself when there are a lot of people around. But that jerk was greedy. He wanted to steal the decorations from Akitsuyugin and sell them for a profit.
Oh, God.
That's why I used my yokai power. To teach him a lesson.
Goddamn.
Ah, so that's what happened. You have a strong sense of justice.
It's Focalos.
By the way, how did you know the rest of the story about Kamai and the samurai?
It's okay if you don't want to tell us. I've already figured it out.
Oh.
Your true form is this pair of Hagoita, isn't it?
Oh?
Hagoita? Oh, wait! So that means she's...
The pair of Hagoita used by Kamai and the human samurai to play Akitsu Hazura hundreds of years ago.
Motherfucker, so she wasn't the fox dude or him, she was... The paddles? Huh? How the fuck was I gonna guess that, dude?
You gradually developed sentience after being influenced by great yokai power.
Wow.
You were the closest to witness their story. Even with the yokai power's blessing, the Hagoita have started to rot away after hundreds of years. You can't sustain yourself, so you were forced to rely on props to scare people.
That's wild.
And if my theory is correct, this pair of Hagoita is also the item we need to find for the third round of the Test of Courage.
Yep.
Excellent work. You figured it all out.
What the fuck are you doing here?
Congratulations, little ones. You've passed the third round of the Test of Courage.
Pog, what's my prize?
Nico? And the Shrine Maiden? Kinda thought you went missing.
Dude, Miko's been in like every event lately.
For causing you concern. It was actually Lady Yai's idea.
Yeah, well, I thought you were the yokai. This woman, you fucking... This is so confusing, but pretty good.
Well, what did you think? Were you scared?
No.
Because fear is induced by uncertainty, the more chaotic the situation, the better. Having the event staff also mysteriously vanish only added to the uncertainty.
Yeah, it literally did.
I must say.
Wow.
I think this test of courage truly lived up to its name.
She's not wrong, and they clearly did that on purpose, because I thought as soon as the Shrine Maiden disappeared from the notice board, that's when I was like, oh, the yokai's obviously her then. Fuck, that's... Okay, Yai, you fucking mental manipulator. What is this? Gaslight girl keep... Gaslight gatekeep girl boss?
For all the scary stuff.
Hitomi, go tell the others that the test of courage has ended and that we have a winner.
Pog. I wonder my prize. What is... Yeah, girl keep. I fucked up the saying, okay? I fucked
now
it up.
Now that I've solved the mystery, I'm going back to meet with my client. The intent to steal is not exactly a serious crime, but it can't go unpunished.
Oh, come on.
I'll see you two later.
Okay. Yeah, gate light.
Miko, did you choose the Hagoita for the third round of the Test of Courage because you already knew about Chizuru?
Had to have done.
Miko, Lady Yae.
Well, Miko has a big connection with the yokai, right? I'm pretty certain. I know she is one, but she has a big connection with them in terms of she holds that big festival, I'm pretty certain. But there's a lot of other yokai that don't have a big connection with the rest of the yokai is my whole point, chat. Just because she is one doesn't mean she has a big connection with them.
I followed Kitsune Saigu around the Mikawa Flower Festival one year and saw her play Akitsu Hazura.
So that was Kitsune Saigu in the back. Aw, dude.
That was when I saw you. You didn't have a human form at the time, and possessed only the earliest traces of sentience.
That's cute.
I remember now. You were on Kitsune Saigu's shoulder.
I went for a stroll on the beach some time ago and sensed a familiar yokai power. Though your power was weak, I was still able to find you. You were sitting in a tree, gazing at the tourists below. I overheard you telling yourself that you must be patient and avoid contact with humans.
Huh? When was that? I didn't notice you at all.
With your powers being so diminished,
she's gonna sneak in.
It was only natural that you didn't notice me. You must have been blaming yourself all this time. You knew Kamai and the samurai became friends as a result of Akitsu Hazura, a game connected to your existence.
At the time, I couldn't take on a human form like this. I had only a hazy sense of the outer world. After they first met at the Mikawa Flower Festival, I felt proud to know that I had left a mark on their story. But after they said their final goodbyes, I could often hear Kamai sighing to himself.
Aww.
I couldn't help but hide. Because I blamed myself. When I woke up again, the world had changed. Lady Yae, you are a well-known yokai. You must know many more things than I do. So I have a question for you. People meet, become friends, and then go their separate ways. After such a short time, they leave only regret and sadness in their wake. Is it really worthwhile for us yokai to interact with humans?
Why not? Tell me, how did you feel when you played Akitsu Yugen with the Traveler?
I felt happy, but...
But your rationality told you that it was wrong, didn't it?
Probably didn't want to die and leave him alone.
It turns out that there is still another piece to the story of Kamai and the samurai that you are missing.
What do you mean? The samurai and Kamai never met again.
Oh, wait, did they?
True, but the story doesn't end there. That samurai's name was Yanagibashi Takuto, who also happens to be the founder of the Soran Ishin art.
Oh.
It is believed that Takuto developed this style of swordsmanship while dueling with Kamai, who had also befriended the third generation heir of the Soran Ishin art, Tominaga Masanari.
Not Masanori, Masanari.
Ago, Kamai and Tominaga fought side by side until their final moments, and the sword Tominaga wielded was passed down from Yanagibashi. The regret Kamai once felt had finally been resolved.
Oh. I never knew.
We yokai are not like humans. Humans have too short a lifespan, and the day will inevitably come when we must say goodbye. However, the bond formed by friendship will not be broken, but rather carried on in a new form. There's no reason to be upset by this. Time flies by in an instant, and life passes by like a dream. So, you must be happy in the present. You should understand what I mean now.
Hey,
compadres!
Fuck's sake.
Ito, what are you doing here?
Oh, this is gonna go great.
You told me everything. And I also heard that you won the last round.
Yeah, we're the winners.
I even know who the ghost lady is now. Anyway, I had a little discussion with the others, and,
You gotta just barge in like...
You're that fox lady. Why are you here?
Oh my god, is this the first time Ito and Yaya meeting? Oh my god, I think it is.
Please just disregard my presence. Now, tell us what you discussed.
Ah, right. All right, listen up. To celebrate the end of the Test of Courage event, we will be holding the Mikawa Flower Festival.
Oh.
I gave it some real thought and realized that it might be kind of difficult for those little yokai to hold the festival on their own. But with my help, it won't be a problem. That's right. Arataki, the one and only Ito, will be in charge of organizing the best Mikawa Flower Festival anyone's ever seen.
Okay, okay, okay. I like the sound of that.
Ito!
Oh.
Can we trust this guy with a festival?
I think it's a good idea.
Hey, what you trying to say? Besides, it won't just be me. Other people will help too. Even my bro Ayato is gonna be there.
Pog.
Everyone's busy getting ready, and the festival
Wait.
Will be up and running in no time.
Oh
it
shit!
It won't be long until you can all join the fun.
But I kind of like this. Is this kind of giving us a sneak peek and a preview that there's gonna be a flower festival soon, run by these guys?
You're the best, Ito.
Oh shit! I kind of like that. If it is, that's not a bad thing. Ito sets up the festival. Oh, never mind. It's right now. You know what? That's cool.
What would a festival be without me?
That's cool.
I'll be sure to go have a look, too.
True. Yeah, what would an event be without you? You've been in every single one.
It has been some time since I've attended a festival. Fortunately, I brought sake with me.
Iridori.
Paimon's gotta admit, Ito does have his moments.
True.
A festival, delicious food, count Paimon in!
Hell yeah. Do you want to join us, Chizuru? You should.
All right, I'll join. If you don't mind, that is.
Of course I don't mind. Join us.
Looks like the festival has started! Let's go check it out!
Wait, what? Oh, okay. Wait, I want to talk to this kid first. What's up, Kappa?
I think I need to take a break.
Okay. What's Toba doing?
Oh, I sure bought a lot of stuff. I'll have to organize it all when I get back.
I want to become a great yokai, like the mighty Urakusai. Then I'll be able to help create a real Mikawa Flower Festival.
Pog, I mean, listen, I think it'd be possible technically, right? I don't know. I think it would be. Oh this is cool.
No. I almost had it.
We need this.
The hang of it, huh?
We need this for the teapot. This would be cool for the teapot. Alright, Ito, let's do this. Let's do this.
Ito and Goro, what are you two talking about?
Oh my god. Please. I would... Listen. I think this is the first time I see them talking together. I would fucking love for Ito to finally find out Goro's team talk secret.
Oh, I was just saying that if I had more time, I'd have built a massive fishing pond here.
Uh-huh.
Fishing? You know, when I lived on Watatsumi Island, I used to just dive into the sea and catch fish with my bare hands.
Take it from an expert, using your hands to catch fish is nowhere near as fun as using a fishing rod. Just the other day, I caught a fish so big that I didn't even know how to handle it. I even wrote a letter to Yae Publishing House about it.
Uh-oh.
That's an unusual problem to have.
Huh? A big fish? How come you didn't tell us? Paimon could have helped you eat it.
I don't think it needs help.
Huh? You wrote a letter to Yae Publishing House?
Oh, God. Wait, is he gonna...
Oh, you bet I did. I wrote to the That's Life column and asked Miss Hina for advice. Ah, she's so amazing. She got back to me really quickly, too.
Is he gonna tell him?
What a coincidence. I do some part-time work there, and I recently received a similar letter.
No way!
You mean the letter was about dealing with a giant fish they caught? No. Could it be? Could it be... that there's someone as good at fishing as I am?
You big stupid fucking idiot.
Not on my watch. Hey, you all go enjoy the festival. I'm gonna get out there and catch an even bigger fish.
You're so stupid.
Just you wait.
Oh my god.
I'll be inviting you all to my fish feast.
I don't think he'll ever acquire the IQ to be able to actually figure out what's going on there.
Aw, the string snapped. I was so close.
God damn it.
Yoimiya, this is more difficult than it looks. Can you really fish out these water balloons with a string?
Real himbo behavior.
Don't worry. Let me show you a little trick. Just remember that your hand has to be quick. Yo-Yo Tsuri! Paimon's seen this game in some light novels before!
Do you want to give it a shot? Close one eye, aim carefully, and fish it out quickly.
Oh. I'll give it a try. Do we actually get to try?
It looks kinda tricky. Paimon will let the traveler another try. You have to catch at least 3 water balloons since there's 3 of us.
Okay.
But Yoimiya, if I close one eye, I won't be able to see anything.
For fuck's sake. Jesus. Okay. Oh my god. Alright, let me play this shit. We got this. Ayaka?
This ramen is so good.
Oh, well, now I'm hungry.
Yes. It feels like it's been ages since the last time I had some.
You mean you don't get to eat ramen very often, Ayaka? But it's so delicious.
Ramen is delicious, dude.
Oh, it's you. We'll need 2 more bowls of ramen, please. Food like ramen and hot pot tend to have a lot of oil and salt, so I don't get to eat them very often.
Now Paimon totally gets why Ayaka would put cake into hot pot.
Huh?
Huh?
Oh, please, no need to bring that up again.
Oh.
I'm stuffed and feeling a little sleepy. I'm just gonna take a nap.
By the way, were there any special stalls at yokai festivals in the past?
Yes, but... well, it's a long story.
Sorry, I just saw Iroh's message. I think I've missed something. Goro, female? Do Goro's hangout. Do it. It's great. It's my favorite hangout, actually.
Paimon can't believe you couldn't get a single water balloon. You've gotten rusty. Chizuru managed to finally get one and gave it to Hitotsume Kozo.
He looked like he really wanted it.
But Paimon wanted one too.
Oh.
All right, then I'll catch one for you next time.
Yay!
Oh, that's cute. That's cute. Honestly, the style of this character is really fucking cool.
Come on now, this is way more expensive than usual. Even if it is a festival, you shouldn't hike up the prices this much.
Hey now, it costs money to run a stall. I need to raise my prices to help cover the expenses, you know?
Fair enough. How about 5 masks for 30% off? Final offer.
Alright, alright.
Interesting. Thomas, you at every festival?
Thomas, so do be haggling. Hot. Feels like I'm being roasted here.
Move then.
Don't get too close. It's better to keep a few steps back.
I know. It's just so rare to see such a nice bonfire.
Aww.
I want to get as close as I can to enjoy it.
Cute.
There are many beautiful things in the world. There's no need to be anxious. The festival has only just begun.
True.
I was surprised that you didn't even tell your sister. It seems she was quite frightened, too.
Oh my god, it's Jesse and James. And we have Sayu here for Meowth. Team Rocket blasted off again. Oh my god, this is incredible. We've got the whole gang. And we have Paimon, the Pokemon.
Had I told her what was going to happen ahead of time. Besides, with her friends by her side, she wouldn't ever be too scared. Having a little fright is good to release any tension she might have accumulated lately.
True.
Everything went according to plan. People started to panic as soon as they sensed that they had no idea what was happening. Oh, how amusing.
Fairly funny.
Yes. Well done.
Damn, these two are masterminds.
Stop laughing! It was scary!
There's the Pokemon.
Have you finished exploring the festival?
Have you finished blasting off again? Just about.
Well then, are you having a good time?
Yes.
Yeah, it's great!
Very good time.
The original Mikawa Flower Festival was much more lively. But even if you could attend the original, you probably wouldn't be as happy as you are now. Because it's always more fun to enjoy a festival with friends, isn't it?
Yeah, true.
Yes. Thank you.
Oh, that's cute,
then,
dude.
I'm guessing you have something you want to say to him alone? We'll leave you in peace.
That's cute.
What did you want to say to us?
You saw through me again. I can't help but feel you somehow know everything.
Also, I do just want to say, I saw a lot of comments in the chat saying, like, the JP voice is so much more elegant and this one is just not as good. If I'm a yokai that is dying for being separated from my body, I think I'd probably sound like this instead of elegant. No? I don't know. I think the voice fits.
It's not that I know everything. It's just that I've been in your position before.
Traveler, do you have a moment?
I'd like to talk to you alone on the beach.
Hard disagree. You disagree with the fact that if you were literally dying and like seriously dying, you think that that person would sound elegant and beautiful instead of like they're dying. I don't know, dude. I just don't agree personally, I guess. Oh, I don't know. I think the voice fits. I think it fits perfectly. Okay, let's speak to them.
Saying goodbye is also part of a festival.
Yes. Every celebration must come to an end.
Interesting. It's not a physical strain like a human. Dying, is it a physical strain? She's not exactly crawling around and dying. It literally said she was dying and that the further away they are from the original object, the weaker they are. So I don't know.
Are you enjoying
She's not exactly
yourself?
Strong.
How about we go eat together?
Not in a prime. Yeah, has it ever been said that yokai don't feel physical strain in that sense? I don't know.
Weird. Where did all the fish go? Don't worry. Let's go try another spot.
Interesting. Pale red crab. I thought that said I could talk to it then. Holy, dude. Oh. Oh.
One bowl of ramen shouldn't hurt, right?
Jesus Christ. God damn it, dude.
Oh, no! I almost had it!
Oh, starting to get the hang of it, huh? Keep trying.
I actually really like her voice. I think her voice is great. But again, different stroke for different folk.
All right, here will do. Thank you for agreeing to come with me.
Don't mention it.
Actually, I was delighted when I first discovered that I could take on a human form. I was a yokai derived from a pair of Hagoita who came into being in the middle of a festival. So naturally, I enjoyed the lively festival atmosphere.
I literally did go to Ita and Goro, and all they said were that all the fish was gone.
I wanted to go to more festivals, become friends with humans, and play Akitsu Yugen with them. But every evening, as night began to set in, I'd recall the bitter smile of the old samurai as he set down the Hagoita, and the lonely Kamai sighing as he drank his sake. Then I would wonder, if I became friends with a human, would that person experience the same melancholy in the future? As a result, I was convinced that I couldn't do it. I told myself I would not repeat that same mistake.
I understand what you mean.
I'm sorry that I spoke so strangely when we first met. I'm sure it must have scared you. I expected you to flee in terror. But when we met again, you acted like you had no trouble being around me. I knew you mistook me as one of the yokai. But instead of telling you the truth, I went and played Akitsu Yugen with you.
Why?
I'm not completely sure myself. Perhaps it's because I've always wanted to be like Kamai and play Akitsu Yugen with humans. Or perhaps it was because I knew I didn't have much time left, and I didn't want to be alone.
Oh, that smile, dude.
Anyway,
that was cute.
Thank you for taking the time to play with me.
Oh, give us the paddles as a teapot item. Let us keep her there.
When we played Akitsu Yugen, Paimon said the loser would have to grant the winner a wish. At the time, I wished for us to never cross paths again.
Yeah, and that was really
However,
fucking rude.
You still came and found me. Meaning, you never granted my wish. So, can I make another wish?
As long as I can fulfill it.
Let me think. I wish for you to remember me. No. I only have one wish. So I better make it count.
Oh.
Okay. Listen carefully. My wish is...
C6 Wanderer. What the fuck?
I wish that every day of your journey ahead will be filled with joy like a festival.
Oh, that's cute. Oh, she's gone! You fuckers! Hoyaverse, I fucking swear to God. You could have at least let us say goodbye. Man. Hey, we got the party thing for the teapot. Pog, dude, that's the one thing I wanted. As well as the NPC lady in the teapot. Is everyone just chilling here now until the event finishes? Wait, Sai is here now. Hello.
I've grown taller.
No, you haven't.
I'm so tall. Everyone else looks so tiny now.
I think you're looking at ants.
Every year when the fireworks go off, I say to myself, another year has already passed. As each year passes by, your life gradually approaches its end.
Jesus fucking Christ, Yomi. Can we celebrate and just be happy for a minute?
But I don't think that's a bad thing. Like I always say, fireworks are for now, but friends are forever.
My God. Okay, yeah, great. Love that. We'll be here for the next... They didn't give you a voice for this part. Are you serious? That's so sad, dude.
After hearing Chizuru describe the original Mikawa Flower Festival, I wanted to arrange another chance to talk with her about it. I didn't expect that would be our last conversation.
Interesting. I also didn't expect that would be our last conversation. Jesse, James, we're blasting off again!
So, did you enjoy the test of courage?
Yes.
Once I learned of the yokai's intentions to hold a festival, I wanted to spread the word and attract people to their event. However, it occurred to me that doing so might be overly ambitious. If we marketed the Mikawa Flower Festival from the get-go, people would have arrived with insatiably high expectations.
True, actually,
so
good
I
point.
So I decided on using the Test of Courage's notoriety to attract visitors, and left the rest to the yokai.
Well, you got a lovely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10... Like, 10 to 11 people attending? It's pretty pog, you know?
I had pretty an pog. Inkling that their presence would spice up the event.
Why, indeed it did. Indeed it did, you little shit. Alright, Yai, what about you?
When Ayato approached me about holding the Test of Courage event, it dawned on me that this would be the perfect opportunity to help Chizuru face her problem. Kamae and the samurai's parting was one of the first things she experienced when
Sorry.
She was partially sentient
God
and
damn
didn't
it.
Have her human form yet.
God, this is really cute, but I'm just seeing the hillage all dancing in the background and it's distracting as shit. I gotta, okay. Oh God, now I can see the, okay.
This was a very traumatic experience for her, and she could never come to grips with it by reasoning alone. The best option for her was to directly interact with humans. There's no need to feel sad. I believe she was content when she left us.
Oh, I believe she was as well, but it's still sad. All right, Hitomi, you sussy baka. Practicing for real long, so I'll actually scare people. Okay. Nothing? Kappa, what about you? I love playing with humans. Bruh, I want to see the actual yokai form. I'm not even kidding. Okay, please say something interesting this time.
Lifespans, partings, it really gets you thinking, doesn't it?
Oh.
But, I got nothing. All I know is I'll never regret meeting you.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, zero brain cells, but at least it's a good job you're fucking hot. I'll put it that way. Jesus Christ.
It is, heartbreaking to learn of Chizuru's story. To be honest, I experience that same kind of sorrow when I'm on the battlefield. I don't know when I'll lose my comrades, so I try to appreciate every moment.
Oh. Can I electrocute both of them?
Right now.
Toma time.
Even though I knew my lord had most likely planned everything before the Test of Courage even began, I was still caught off guard. But in retrospect, it was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Festival event dialogues, depression. Kind of.
Will you have some time in the next few days, Kazuma? I'd like you to work on a case with me.
Oh, interesting. Oh,
did you run into some trouble? Not exactly. It's just an old case with almost no tangible leads. But I believe your attuned sense of nature might allow us to discover some new clues. Sure. I can stay after the festival and we can go investigate together. Great. Thank you. My pleasure. It's no trouble at all.
Old case with no tangible leads, eh? Kind of fitting, since the old case would still exist of Scarra's shit, and now nobody remembers who the fuck he is.